Gold is valued at $1,176 per ounce, and according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $251. Antiwar.com reports with the latest reports out of the UN saying some 80% of the Yemeni population is now in need of humanitarian aid. Saudi warplanes continued to pound the country, and Saudi warships continue to enforce a blockade through which only a handful of ships have been allowed, delivering a pittance of the aid needed. One would think this would add a new sense of urgency to ending the ongoing Saudi war against Yemen, but this apparently is not the case, with the pro-Saudi faction, the remnants of the former Hadi government, rejecting the idea of not even having a new peace talk at all. The last round of peace talks with the Shiite Houthis ended last week, rather unceremoniously, when Hadi negotiators attacked a Houthi press conference in Geneva, throwing shoes at the speakers and starting a fist fight. According to the UN, that was the only time during the entire week that the two sides were even in the same room. President Hadi resigned in January, and the Saudis insist on reinstalling him with this ongoing war. Hadi's aides insisted that there was nothing to talk about until the Houthis, who control most of the country, are prepared to unilaterally surrender all the major cities to them. That tactic is risky. Hadi was never a particularly popular ruler installed at the behest of the U.S. and Saudi officials in a single candidate vote. That his faction is seen opposing the peace talks and backing a bloody Saudi war that's killed thousands is likely to add to resentment against him.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports a video of an altercation between a SEPTA police officer trying to arrest a man carrying his young daughter for allegedly evading paying the $2.25 subway fare has gone viral. According to NBC Philadelphia, a cashier notified transit police about the fare after Ella Smith entered the Market Frankfurt L at the Margaret Orthodox station on Thursday. The video, captured by transit authority cameras, showed the officer forcefully shoving Smith by the throat while he held his toddler. During a press conference on Thursday, Police Chief Thomas Nestle III said an internal investigation is underway and that his department does not teach people to do that. According to Nestle, William Crawford, the officer involved, feared disciplinary action if he walked away. The officer's supervisor said, "That's a failure on my part. We never want a child's safety to be jeopardized." Nestle said Smith declined to give identification and refused to leave the train. The video shows Crawford speaking with Smith for around 6 minutes before physical force was used. After backup officers arrived, he was handcuffed while still holding his child, who appeared to be between 1 and 2 years old. Another passenger held the child while he was arrested. Smith was charged with fare evasion, disorderly conduct, and resisting arrest, and the child was placed into the care of her mother.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Greek lawmakers on Sunday authorized a proposed July 5th ballot referendum that came from Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras, which sets Greece on a course for a plebiscite that has enraged international creditors and increased Greece's chance of exiting the Eurozone. The government easily passed the 151-vote threshold needed to authorize the referendum, with deputies from the far-right Golden Dawn voting with the government and pro-European opposition parties New Democracy, PASOK, and Topotomi, and the KKE Communist Party voting against. Greeks are due to vote on whether to accept or reject the latest terms offered by the creditors to Athens in order to unlock billions of euros in bailout funds. European partners have reacted negatively to the announcement of the referendum. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Police in Lehman, Michigan describe a local student's recently foiled plans to commit a deadly school shooting as, quote, embarrassingly bad. Authorities apprehended 17-year-old Trent Bayer Thursday after finding him in an empty hallway struggling to load a pathetically small caliber pistol while simultaneously attempting to unfold an inaccurate map of the school. Lehman Police Chief Ethan Holman elaborated several ways Bayer's strategy could have been more effective, including setting off a homemade explosive in the teacher's lounge, executing popular students first, and at the very least, purchasing some military fatigues.
You're not going to intimidate anyone by wearing a tucked-in button-down shirt and pleated trousers.
In other news, a jar of change on a dresser is sadly factoring into a number of financial decisions. A teen zebra doesn't give a shit how much you honk, it's not getting out of the road. And dad's new 20-year-old Thai boyfriend really sucks at categories. And don't forget to never, ever drink Pepsi-Cola, whose dipshit marketing team backed out of a full-page ad buy at the last minute. For more news, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. We are here doing the live Sunday edition of the program. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And we just got back, or at least Mark and I did. David Lee did not attend the Porcupine Freedom Festival this year, but
Mark, every 3 years, whether I need it or not.
You take a couple years off, basically?
Well, I wanted to. I make it to maybe every other one.
So it was a great event. Just, you know, kind of brief recap here. If you missed it, there's, of course, a week's worth of Free Talk Live starting last Sunday through last night. And I apologize for not getting last night's archive up until this afternoon. Our archive guy was at camp. He came up to Porkfest. It was actually Chris Cantwell who was working behind the scenes, helping us out with doing the archives during the week. And even though he's banned from Porkfest, he actually showed up across the street.
It's hilarious. There's this little pull-off across the street.
It's like a scenic view kind of pull-off.
Yeah, one of those scenic view kind of pull-offs. And he just parks out there and has himself his own little Porkfest, and people come out to say hi.
He brought out free beer for people who would come out to see him, and that was awfully nice. So he hung out there. Actually, he was just kind of initially thinking about coming out just to sort of make a quick appearance and say hi to some of his fans. And he ended up staying there for 12 hours just hanging out. Out across from Porkfest. So Porkfest
comes to you.
Yeah, Porkfest was fun. If you missed it again, go to freetalklive.com, grab archives there. Of course, I'm sure pictures will be posted at some point, presumably to the Porkfest page on Facebook, but honestly, I don't know where they're going to end up. And I took a few pictures as well. I tried to get some sunrise pictures earlier this week, and I think I might have gotten some good ones. I actually haven't had a chance to review those yet. I always like to catch a good sunrise if possible during the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
The really, really good people and the really, really bad people see sunrises.
Yeah, I can see an argument for that. So, like I said the other night, I don't know what's been going on in the news. I know there's a situation developing over in Greece where apparently there is a run on the banks that is happening now. And I think that's probably an interesting story. So let's start with that here tonight. And then coming up, since we just finished the Porcupine Freedom Festival, and it has been compared to Burning Man, it's been called the Libertarian Burning Man.
Yeah.
And apparently the Burning Man is in the news. The government wants a ridiculous $1 million VIP compound from the Burning Man founders, from the people who are putting Burning Man together, for, I guess, elite government agents who will be on the ground there at Burning Man. We'll talk more about that. It's absolutely ridiculous. But first, from Greece, and by the way, Dave Ridley joining us here tonight. You won't be on Wednesdays for a little while, Dave. You're going out to Colorado, is that right?
A mix of Colorado and Bedford, probably.
All right, so we'll look forward to seeing you again behind the microphone as soon as possible. It's good to have you in here for one last night. So, of course, those Thanks. Of you who know him from RidleyReport.com. Here's a story from Vice News at Vice.com. Panicked Greek citizens lined up at ATMs around the country on Saturday following an early morning announcement by Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras that he would seek to put the final terms of a bailout offer as a referendum before the Greek people. Tsipras has said that he said that the terms requested by the Eurozone countries in exchange for an extension of the bailout would be too hard on the average Greek citizen. And basically, he said Saturday morning, quote, the Greek government was asked to accept a proposal that will add new unbearable weight to the shoulders of the Greek people and that will undermine the recovery of the Greek economy and society, not only by fueling uncertainty, but also by further exacerbating social inequalities. Now, I have to say, I haven't been following this closely, but from what I heard from Chris Cantwell, and he has been watching this fairly closely, is there's like some sort of commie government that was elected in Greece, and they're basically screwing things up even worse than things have already been screwed up there.
Well, yeah, there's just different concepts out there, like the idea that that somehow austerity doesn't work. And I will grant that austerity shouldn't be necessary if governments act in a responsible fashion. And I'm talking about today's statist paradigm, okay? I'm not trying to give any advice beyond that. If you want a government to function well, make it compete in the marketplace, and it will have to. But nonetheless, so, I mean, you know, the idea here is that no, we don't need to cut spending in order to be able to do things, you know, be able to make our budgets and these sort of things and pay back our bills. We can continue. All you do is grow into these things. And I mean, it's ridiculous.
So there's apparently an offer for a bailout on the table, but he's saying the terms are too hard on the average Greek citizen to accept. So I guess the terms would be some more austerity measures or something like that, I presume. I mean, I haven't read the terms of the bailout, obviously. But his unexpected announcement angered finance ministers, according to Vice, of the 19 countries that hold Greece's debt. They have been locked in tense negotiations with the Greeks for the past 5 months. Greece had been...
This is really easy. If you ever loan anybody money, you know, I mean, you know, you've loaned some people some money in the past, enough money that it kind of hurts a little bit. And then you see, you know, I'm not talking about a few cents here, like $2 or something like that, and they just forget to pay it back. I'm talking about, you know, whatever that amount is for you. It could be 200, it could be 2,000, it could be 20,000. I don't know who your friends are and how much money you have. I'm just saying that, you know, these are some numbers that might hurt. And you loan that person some money and they don't seem real interested in paying it back. They're going out every night.
Oh yeah.
They're they're drinking. You see them stopping off and buying those $5 cups of coffee. They're just having a grand old time.
All those things they could not be doing, and they could instead be making payments.
Right. That's how that feels for these countries here.
Yeah.
You see, the whole concept that austerity isn't necessary is always made by these people who owe all the money. Look, I understand it's not the individual Greeks that are responsible for this. It's their government. But they elected it. I mean, it's not like, you know, it's not like there's a whole bunch of libertarians running around Greece. This is irresponsible fiscal policy. Yep. I'll tell you, the bankers, it's rigged. Yep, the whole financial system, it's rigged. But you're either going to pay these countries back their money or you're not, because it's not the banks that are loaning the money out. It's the countries, as I understand it. It's not the central bank of the euro.
So more from the story here. They've been locked in tense negotiations. They had been Greece had been scheduled to make a payment of 1.6 billion euros to those countries on Tuesday, June 30th. If the referendum is approved, that payment will be deferred until after the vote takes place on July 5th.
Greece. So who was it supposed to be paid to? I'm sorry.
The 19 countries that hold Greece's debt.
Okay.
So they were supposed to make 1.6 billion euros worth of payments on Tuesday. Greece asked, it's Tuesday the 30th, so they're going to, if it's approved, the payment will be deferred until after the vote takes place on July 5th. Greece asked to extend its bailout through that period, but the Eurogroup head said on Saturday Greece's request had been rejected. If no agreement is reached between now and Wednesday, when the bailout is set to expire, the European Central Bank will end the emergency line of credit that it has extended to the Greek banks. Without the credit to draw on, the banks are likely to collapse. If that happens, the Greek government would have to step in and print a new currency, effectively phasing out the euro. On Saturday morning, while the Greek banks are in a pretty serious situation here, and Wednesday is sort of the deadline, so people are already lining up at ATMs around the country on Saturday morning. While the country's parliament debated whether or not to approve the referendum, Bloomberg News reported that as many as 500 of 7,000 ATMs around the country have already run out of cash. Some institutions were imposing withdrawal limits, while others were concerned they would not be able to open on Monday without a cash infusion from the Bank of Greece.
So it's like they're a part of this sort of authoritarian union. They don't have their independence anymore, and they aspire to be independent the way Honduras is, so they can be like Honduras and have hyperinflation. Well, that's not the perfect example, but, you know, like Zimbabwe and have hyperinflation all the time. That's what they aspire to. And it's like it never occurs to anyone to aspire to a third way.
And what would the third way be?
Freedom.
Of course, it doesn't occur to the government officials to try freedom. Of course, that would be the best option.
Imagine how fast things would get, not back to normal, but better than they've ever been in Greece.
Yeah, no doubt.
I think that there's probably a pretty good argument that if you attempt, I don't know what you're referring to specifically with freedom, but if you were to have a responsible fiscal policy from the state of Greece, that it would probably get worse before it got better, but it would probably be a relatively short period of time, and then there wouldn't be so many booms and there wouldn't be booms and busts after
well,
that.
Well, don't worry, guys. The Bank of Greece has promised in a statement issued Saturday, the flow of cash would not be interrupted. Everything's going to be totally fine. Pay no attention to what's going on.
Oh, attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from hiddenholster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. The original hidden holster.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I'm Mark Stevens of the No Stay Project, and are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By By using their money, you're only helping the government. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, spread it. So get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live here on the Live Sunday edition. Of course, you can bring up anything that you would like to discuss. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Peacekeeper 2.0, it is in the development stages. They're actually, I guess technically in the fundraising for the development stage. They'd like to raise some money to develop Peacekeeper 2.0 because Peacekeeper 1.0, while it was a brilliant concept, had some problems in its execution. There were some bugs with the first version of Peacekeeper, and they need to get ironed out. And unfortunately, it costs money to do programming, unless you want it to take forever. And so they're going to be hiring somebody. And by the way, I was told that the amount that they're asking for here for the fundraising goal is actually lower than what it costs to program apps like Android and iPhone apps. So apparently, whoever it is they're going to be hiring is giving them a pretty good deal on programming, from what I've been told. So Peacekeeper is an idea of bringing people together to respond sort of in a decentralized manner to people who are having issues, whatever it's maybe a health issue, some sort of an emergency
service issues.
Yeah, emergency service like fire or an abduction. These are the kind of alerts that you can send out over the Peacekeeper app. And then other Peacekeeper users get those alerts if they're in the area, or at least that was the idea. The first version only allowed you to add people that you knew, but the new version is going to allow anyone who's got the Peacekeeper app in the given area that the alert is happening to respond. So the idea being that average folks, your neighbors, the people who might be in your neighborhood or your friends or family members who might be nearby, who have the the chops, the medical EMT kind of chops, or
sometimes
they can grab a fire hose
with a garden hose. Yeah. Sometimes that's all you need.
Right. So somebody who can respond quickly to a situation. So they want to make Peacekeeper better, and they're doing a fundraiser right now. You can go to pk.freetalklive.com if you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means. Contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today at pk.freetalklive.com.
If you think how useful the Porcupine 411 application was, as a sort of partial substitute for 911, it's going to be nice to see something maybe taking this even further.
Yeah, I'm excited about it. I am looking forward to it because I really wanted the first version to be awesome, and it was a little disappointing. So I'm glad they're working on version 2. And it sounds like they really have the right ideas.
The theory
is
solid.
Yeah. So pk.freetalklive.com. Let's go to, we'll go to your calls if you make them here. 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about the people in Greece who are, as of Saturday morning at least, that's when I saw this article yesterday. And it was Saturday morning apparently where 500 of 7,000 ATMs in Greece had run out of cash. Some institutions imposing withdrawal limits, others concerned they won't be able to open on Monday without a cash infusion from the Bank of Greece, which the bank may not be able to do very effectively if apparently this, this referendum that has been put out there is approved. There's this big payment, this $1.6 billion euro payment that the Greek government owes to basically the euro group. And this payment deadline may be extended until after a vote takes place on July 5th. Now, I'm not really clear about what they will be voting. I guess it's a request for a referendum at midnight it's a little muddled for me because I'm not in Greece, but things are not looking good for the people there, and so they're desperately trying to get their cash out and maybe turn it into Bitcoin. Here's an update from financialpost.com. Bitcoin is the real winner in the Greece crisis, from John Schmuel.
Now, this is the financial – what is this? The Financial
Post.
Okay, I'm not familiar with the site, but I mean, it sounds legit, doesn't it?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is legit.
Okay.
And why wouldn't it be? I mean, this is a great explanation for why Bitcoin's price has gone up over the last couple of weeks.
Well, let's hear the explanation then.
Grexit fears may be taking a toll on stock and bond prices this month, but it has been a boon for virtual currency Bitcoin. The virtual currency has been steadily climbing this month as talks have broken down between Greece and its creditors. Invented 6 years ago as an alternative to fiat currencies, Bitcoin has now climbed nearly 10% in the past few days. And on Wednesday, the value of one Bitcoin rose 1.54%, or $3.86, to over $250. The main driver for Bitcoin prices seem to be Greek buyers. Joshua Skyla, the co-founder of Voltoro.com, told Reuters this week his company has seen a 124% pickup in web hits from Greek IP addresses. If Greece does exit the Eurozone, it is unclear what currency the country would use. Since it currently trades in euros, another concern is the possibility that the Greek government could implement capital controls in their country's banks soon.
The best bet for the Greek people is as if their country doesn't, doesn't call any particular money currency, because people will figure it out relatively quickly. They'll use gold, they'll use silver, they'll use bitcoins, whatever is convenient for them.
Yeah, but that wouldn't be the best bet for the Greek government, right?
Absolutely. Look, imagine for a second that you could print money. That would be really awesome for you, right?
Yeah.
Like, the bad thing for the Greek government is being involved in the euro, where it can't just print money on its own and create money out of thin air. Of course, once it does start printing money, it'll just go into hyperinflation.
So I think it's highly likely that the Greek government will be printing its own money. That's just speculation based on the fact that those government guys want power.
Communists and socialists are generally people with good intention that don't understand economics.
Many Greeks have been pulling out their savings, fearing the effects a default would have on Greece's financial system. Bitcoin got a boost from a similar situation, as you may recall, in Cyprus in 2013. Remember when the Cyprus government took money out of their people's bank accounts? A lot of those people saw that coming, and they decided to get their money out first and turn it into Bitcoin. The country saw capital controls imposed on banks in exchange for a bailout from the European Central Bank, and Bitcoin prices surged 700%. From March to April as a result. But while the Greek crisis has been a boon for Bitcoin, the virtual currency is still far off from its peak high of nearly $1,000 set in late 2013. Even with a recent rally, the value of Bitcoin has been essentially flat this year, probably because it continues to be an unreliable alternative to fiat currencies.
Well, it's funny how the authoritarians whined about, oh, it's too unstable. You can't use it. It's unstable. As soon as it's stable, oh, you can't use it. It's not going up 15% a year like it was last year.
Yeah, well, there's always something to critique about Bitcoin, but the fact is it's there and it works. Bitcoin works well, and it is decentralized. It was not created by a government, not created by a bank. It's really the currency of people. People made Bitcoin. Somebody named Satoshi Nakamoto released it to the world 6 years ago, and ever since it's been an open source project that anybody with the right programming skills can get involved in and try to improve upon. It's money that is regularly improved upon. There have been multiple versions of the Bitcoin software that have already been released, and I think it's still technically in beta.
Yes.
So, I mean, we're still on the very beginning of the Bitcoin phenomenon here, and we're seeing it all around the world.
If it was a crackable, counterfeitable currency, and it's not.
That would have happened by now.
They would have done that by now. Like, the crackers would have done that by now.
Right. And again, this is the opinion of the Financial Post, that it's an unreliable alternative to fiat currencies. Why? Why are they claiming that it's an unreliable alternative? What could be more reliable than Bitcoin? I mean, the only way Bitcoin would not be reliable is if you don't have any internet anymore.
That's true. I mean, there were times at the Porcupine Freedom Festival I couldn't spend because I didn't have internet connectivity.
Yep, that's a problem.
That kind of stunk. But, yep. I mean, I was nestled in the White Mountains of New Hampshire at a campground with 2,000 people or so.
Well, at the same time that I couldn't spend Bitcoin once, I also couldn't use my credit card because the guy didn't have internet to do his credit card transactions.
Yeah, it's true.
So, just as unreliable in that case as the credit card. 855-450-FREE. We'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts coming up. Burning Man. It's Free Talk Live.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle. Now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com. OneSilverSolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
If you're looking for work, there's a piece of paper more important than your resume. It's the cover letter attached if you're snail mailing, or the email to which you attach your resume. Make it four short paragraphs. Paragraph one, say that you're applying for work. The person you're sending to gets a ton of mail about all sorts of things. If you have a password, that's your first sentence. Tom Nelson tells me you and I should meet. Paragraph two, what you do and how that relates to the opening. Be as specific as possible. Paragraph three, why you want this particular job. I'm originally from Boston, so I know the market well. I have family and friends in the area, so this would be a homecoming for me. Paragraph four, unless the job posting stipulates no calls, and I will call you to follow up. Thank you in advance for your time. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
They believe, I think, that government can be good as long as you just elect the right people, which, of course, is nonsense. Government can never be good because it's an agency of coercive force. It doesn't matter who's running it. It doesn't matter what the goals of the organization are. As long as it's funded through coercion, as long as it's funded through threats of violence, then nothing it can do is ever moral or justified. They understand the system and they want to work inside it to change it. So, therefore, in order to have their hunger strike that they planned, which I thought was a great idea, they went to the government, and what'd they do?
Ask for a permit?
They asked for a permit. It was already over at that point, right? Whenever you ask permission from the government, you might as well expect them to say,
no.
No!
You know what? It sounds like government has this non-cooperation thing down to a science.
Yeah, right?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I forgot to mention, we are back on Skype as well. You can Skype in now at username lrn.fm. You've been waiting to get us on Skype because we haven't had it for the last week as we've been in the middle of the woods in New Hampshire where internet access was spotty at best, so Skype would have been impossible. But here, we're back in the Keene studios, so we're good to go as far as bandwidth goes, although the cable modem's been acting a little wonky tonight. You should be all right. Call us on Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm, and if you haven't yet sent a request via Skype, you need to do that. Send a friend request over or a contact request, and we will approve it. And once you're approved, you're good to go to call us on Skype from that point forward. So again, Skype username lrn.fm. It's Ian Ridley and Mark in the studio here tonight. Any other comments, guys, on Greece and what's going on there, Bitcoin, et cetera?
It's
going
to be good to see. We need a preview as to how these things are going to unfold, what it looks like, what comes after, so we can all be ready for it. And Greece is sort of the canary in the coal mine, and they'll show us a little bit of how it's going to look in the United States when it plays out here.
Isn't
globally
the debt to GDP in the United States actually worse than Greece?
That's what I've heard.
Yeah. So I mean, I think that what Greece is a country with a high debt to GDP ratio that cannot print its own money. The United States, however, is a country with a high debt to GDP ratio that can print its own money
and make foreign countries take it.
Yeah, to some extent that's true, but it's not as strong of a position as it has been in the past. So I don't know what's going to happen in the future for the U.S. I think this is just essentially a warning. There are lots of people that will chime in and say something to the effect of, this is the bankers destroying Greece for their own purposes or whatever.
This is just politicians doing their political thing.
Bankers and politicians, are they really different people?
Well, I think the bankers probably got the wealth that they would get, but it's just that the state, the politicians in Greece didn't. They're not playing the game, right? They signed up for a game, which is to say fiat currency. That's the name of the game. And the bankers win that game every time, but the politicians come in second, and the rest of us are all robbed and left to the side of the road.
Right, the politicians, when you say they come in second, they benefit because they get to funnel the bank's money to their buddies in industry and get, you know, campaign contributions and kickbacks and golden parachutes and things like that out of the deal. And so, yeah, the rest of us that get the devalued currency at the end of the day are the ones who certainly do get screwed. So you're welcome to share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. I think there are some takeaways that we can get from this. Like you mentioned, this is a warning. This is, Dave, something that people should look at to see how things could go in the future, perhaps in the United States or in another country. Like, this could affect you wherever it is that you live, this kind of behavior by government bureaucrats and central bankers. So what do you do? Well, I would say, you know, and I'm no financial expert, but I would say diversify a little bit. Take some of your money that you have in savings, if you have it saved as dollars or, you know, whatever, euros or whatever currency is the currency du jour in your country, and turn it into something else. Turn it into gold and silver. Turn it into Bitcoin. Turn it into all three of those things. Just diversify a little bit. Obviously, you can only take stuff. You can only take money and turn it into gold and silver or Bitcoin that you can afford to lose. But keep in mind that you might lose your money anyway in some sort of crazy government currency crisis. You know, if they do what Cyprus did and come in and steal money right out of your bank account, what was it, 45% I think Cyprus stole or something ridiculous like that out of large bank accounts. I don't know if there was a limit on the size of the account as far as, you know, did they mess with the people?
They called it a haircut.
Yeah.
If you remember that, they just took a certain amount of, I don't know exactly what it was, but they gave everybody a haircut.
Right.
Nice.
And they took the cuttings for themselves. So, you know, you can do something now. That way you're not caught in the run on the banks. You don't want to be the person in the line at the ATM only to find out that the ATM has run out of cash and that the bank has closed and that you can't get in to access your account.
Sure.
There's no teller there.
That can't happen with Bitcoin. That can't happen with gold and silver that you have control over.
Yeah, exactly. So that's all I'm suggesting. I'm not saying take all of your money and put it in these alternative currencies, but you should have some alternative currencies, in my opinion. What do you think, Ridley?
There are quite a few to pick from now. I mean, you know, you got all the four metal bullions plus Bitcoin plus the altcoins. It's a little easier now to diversify without being in the government sanctioned economic system.
Absolutely. But you've got to take a little bit of forethought, a little bit of time out now.
Well, a lot of people consider these things to be risky.
And well, Bitcoin, I don't think it's that risky, but yeah, the altcoins probably are.
Well, and altcoins, I'm not going to go that far.
Altcoins are the competitors to Bitcoin.
But, you know, like gold and silver and these sorts of things also are considered risky. Like,
didn't silver drop down of like 15 bucks recently?
At some point. It's not too far from that.
Yeah.
But
if silver is considered volatile.
But imagine how things look when they shut the bank down and you can't get to your euros. I mean, euros are looking pretty risky in Greece right now.
Safety and risk and risk and safety. If you put your money in a bank, you are guaranteed to get Jack S-bomb out of it. You are not going to get, what, a 1% rate of return, 2%?
That
doesn't even count. I mean, that's like losing money.
I mean,
you're guaranteed to lose money if you put it in the bank because it's going to go down in value.
You can't even get ahead of the rate of inflation if you put it into a CD account at a bank. I mean, a savings account or checking account, you're not even going to get 1%, I don't think, at most banks these days. I mean, it's been a while since I've looked at the rates, but last time I looked, it was below 1%.
on a savings account.
Yeah, yes, it is.
Or checking. So, yeah, I mean, you want to talk about risky. It's risky to leave all your eggs in one basket. That's risky, right? So if you've got your eggs in a few different baskets, you're a little bit safer. So keep that in mind. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to talk about Greece or Bitcoin or whatever's on your mind, we'll change gears, though, and talk about the Burning Man Festival, which is, of course, coming up later this summer. I don't have the exact dates in front of me, but it's usually sometime in August. Actually, here it is. August 30th to September 7th is when it will be this year. Now, the U.S. Bureau of Land Management officials are asking Burning Man organizers to provide excessive comforts such as flushing toilets, washers and dryers, and vanity mirrors in a compound for high-level government officials staying in Black Rock City. An exclusive report from the Reno Gazette Journal has found this from USA Today.
I mean, if they want to be there, they should supply their own stuff. They've got all kinds of these vehicles that can do all those things for their agents.
But here's the reason why, in my opinion. Now, I haven't done a lot of digging here, but I'm just going to speculate here, Mark. Burning Man is held on government property. It's held on Bureau of Land Management land, and it has been ever since the beginning. They really need to get it the hell off of the public land and have it on private property. But, you know, they've been doing things the way they've been doing things, and now the government's getting more demanding.
Rapacious.
So a Burning Man spokesperson estimated the compound would cost the event more than $1 million, bringing its 2015 permit fees to $5 million.
You want to have a party? $5 million bucks.
Yeah. The renderings of the compound obtained by the Reno Gazette Journal also show various accommodations set aside for VIP visitors, but don't indicate who the visiting dignitaries will be. Bureau of Land Management officials are also demanding a long list of food items, including Choco Tacos, M&M's, licorice, and Chobani Greek yogurt. I mean, these guys think they're Van Halen or, somebody.
No green M&M's.
Yeah, this is what it sounds like. You know, you've seen these riders or you've heard about them on concert promoters. Usually it's the promoter who has to go and get the M&M's and pick the green M&M's out or, you know, get the Shasta soda or whatever it is that the picky star is looking for in the green room to snack on. That's exactly what this sounds like.
I've heard an explanation for this that sort of, you know, softens it up for the stars. I'm not willing to go that far. I mean, you and I, we show up at events and sometimes we'll end up in the green room or whatever. But, you know, like, what the claim is that these guys spend months on the road, right? And this is their, in many cases, their only time, you know, like they're either on a bus, they're in a green room, or they're in a hotel room, right? And so they get their food there in the green room many times. They can't go out and run out and get their food or whatever.
Yep.
So the I've heard whoever was asking for the green M&Ms, and I'm not sure who it was, but some major touring band. That was just sort of an indication as to how well they were going to be taken care of, is what the idea was there. It still sounds snotty to me.
It really sounds snotty. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. If you want to talk about Burning Man, maybe you're a burner and you want to give your thoughts. Has the event totally jumped the shark, and did that happen a few years ago? What's the status of Burning Man these days? 855-450-FREE. If you're a burner, you want to get on the line, feel free, or bring up anything on Free Talk Live.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off.
Hypercronius. ZOG.Ninja. Co. FTL.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. More to come about the Bureau of Land Management demand of a $1 million VIP compound to be provided to their government elite at Burning Man, the yearly festival thrown in Black Rock Desert of Nevada. We can talk more about that here and some of the ridiculous demands that they are making in order for to grant a permit to the festival to continue this year. And it's coming up, by the way. I mean, this thing's at the end of August, so we're only 2 months out from the beginning of Burning Man, and they still haven't finished the negotiations for the deal. Anyway, we'll continue that with that here. 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything.
I got a chance to get my copy of Quantum Vibe at the Porcupine Freedom Festival, Quantum Vibe Volume 3. It will be available from booksellers starting the last day of June, so very, very shortly. You can check out Quantum Vibe, the webcomic, if you haven't experienced it yet, at quantumvibe.com. So the first three volumes are complete, and the new series, Quantum Vibe Venus 23 has already launched, and they've started off in a new series, and so check it out. It's a great time to get involved in the series. quantumvibe.com. It's a pro liberty epic science fiction web comic story. quantumvibe.com.
All right, let's go to Justin. He is on the road in Iowa. Justin, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ridley, and Mark.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Hey, go ahead, sir.
So I wanted to kind of you guys are talking about the crisis of Greek and Greece, and then comparing it to America, and all the politicians and the bankers are really making, you know, money hand over fist with it, and then the average everyday Joe Blow pretty much gets screwed.
Yep.
You know,
that's how it goes. Yeah.
I agree, but I believe that we're kind of getting what we deserve. The average consumer of a developed nation is overly consumed, pardon the pun, with the Joneses syndrome, like they talk about in business school and everything.
In 2005, Americans spent more money than they made.
Yeah.
It's an incredible thing to say, isn't it?
It is. But we allow ourselves for this stuff to happen is kind of what I'm getting at. We're allowing these politicians, we're allowing these bankers to completely screw everybody. And everybody complains about it. And then we just keep on letting all these politicians and bankers and countries around the world and our country just keep screwing everybody.
Do you kind of feel like, to some extent, this is me just asking you, do you think that Americans have to some extent learned their lesson? I can tell you in my family, we are much better with money now than we were before. We eat our meals in. We even grow some of our own food. I'm not entirely sure that is actually a fiscally conservative thing to do because, frankly, I think we spend more money per pound in vegetables than we growing our own than we can at buying at the store. But I think you can definitely save money by buying, making your food at home, and especially
for sure.
Like coffee. It's ridiculous what we spend on coffee. You can get the best coffee in the world, brew it at home, and still pay a tenth of what you would buying crappy coffee out.
But wait, Justin, when you say...
I want to answer the question.
I didn't know there was a question.
There's a question. Do you think Americans are better?
I think we are, but we're not. I think it's we're getting better at spending our money more wisely, but we're still allowing ourselves to be, pardon the cheap, cheesy word, buffaloed by all these large companies and not really putting our foot down and saying, hey, without us, none of this would go on.
Well, okay, so when I'm sorry, what was the word?
Buffaloed.
Buffaloed? What does that mean?
Yeah.
BS'd.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Well, first of all, I mean, it's not really the large companies that are controlling the monetary policy. It's the U.S. government and the central bank.
Central banks, large companies.
Ultimately, that are doing that. And, I mean, as far as Americans letting it happen, what are they supposed to do besides get into alternative currencies like I'd suggested earlier? I mean, what else? You know, you can't stop the central bank from printing money, but you can stop using it, but the average person isn't about ready to do that. So, I mean, what's a realistic fix for the problem?
You know, I never claim to, you know, say that I know all the answers, but I'm pretty sure on this. If we started actually electing real politicians that actually care
real
about
politicians. Well, that's something that's like what, like real cancer?
Okay.
And everybody makes a joke about that, but it's so true, though, too.
Yeah, I would agree with you entirely that if we had better politicians in there, we would have a better government. But the problem is that we have been trying this system of having better politicians for 230 years, and we have the system that we have because people elect the people that they I need a better answer than somehow I have to convince half of the voting public because I haven't been able to do that so far. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
Right. I mean, so Justin, I didn't mean to really put you up hard against the fence there, but, you know, I knew that was
okay.
I kind of had a feeling that's where you were going to go with this because that's sort of the stock answer is, well, if things are bad, then we need better politicians. And, of course, that's what everybody says every 4 years in the United States, and people seem to think that change is even possible in Washington, D.C., and I just don't believe it for a moment. I think you can elect all kinds of new politicians, and of course, that's not whatever happens. People always reelect the same a-holes. It's a 90-plus percent incumbency. They just keep getting reelected. It doesn't matter what they do or how awful that they've been. They keep getting reelected. But even if you were to overturn the entirety of Washington, D.C. and put all new politicians in place, you'd still have the same problems because you'd then have a new batch of people who are seeking power. You know, these people run for political office not because they care about you or because they care about freedom or anything like that. They're running for office because they care about them and they care about their buddies and rewarding their friends and punishing their enemies. And they want to have a way to do that with the, you know, the guns of the government at their disposal. So you would see no significant change in any kind of monetary policy. Certainly a new president or a new House of Representatives isn't going to dismantle the Federal Reserve. They're not going to shut down the military, which, of course, is the organization that benefits the greatest from the Federal Reserve's printing of money because they get to use that printing press to go off to various different wars around the
world.
Wars
are darn expensive. When you make things and then blow them into pieces, you're spending a lot of money.
So, I mean, I don't want to be the person who's saying nothing can be done. I don't believe that. I think something can be done, but it's nothing short-term. A voting at an election is a short-term fix, or at least people seem to think that it is. And, of course, it's not going to fix anything, ultimately. Any other thoughts you want to share?
Yeah, I think that, I want to more elaborate on my stock answer is I believe it has to be done in more of a small scale because, like you said, it is very long. It's very long-term. Human beings have a tendency to be very short-sighted, and I think it has to be done in a small scale. City council has to slowly build its way up. So the general Joe Blow people like myself, yourself, can start working into the larger options. Overhauling Washington is an impossible feat. You know, Washington, D.C. is a worldwide organization that
it really is.
Huge precedence in the whole world. You know, when people talk about the American dollar crashing, I kind of laugh because I'm like, I really don't think that would ever be allowed to happen because there's so many countries that rely on our business and our money. And it would be a disaster.
They
worldwide.
Do. But they also have their own monies. So China has its yuan and Russia has its ruble, and those countries would benefit from the United States, the U.S. dollar ceasing to be the world reserve currency. But so when you're talking about working on the local level, I tend to agree. It's one of the reasons I picked up stakes and moved from Florida, which, you know, Sarasota, Florida, whitest beach sand in the world, pretty nice place to live. But I decided, you know what? I want to be around other people who believe like me, and I moved to New Hampshire for the Free State Project. And it's still beautiful here in different ways.
Northeast is great.
What's that?
He said the Northeast.
Yeah,
The Northeast is great.
Yeah, and what we've done is we've got collected about 1,700 people are in state for the Free State Project, and it's beginning to have a real effect on New Hampshire, which is already rated by the Mercatus Center as one of the freest states in the Union. And I think this is the best bet,
I agree.
Working on a state and local level.
But only if you love liberty. I mean, if you want to control other people, if you want to tell other people how to live their lives, then you definitely don't want to come to New Hampshire. But Justin, thanks for the call tonight, man. I do appreciate the thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And I do agree that, if you can change things locally, that's the best bet. And certainly in New Hampshire, you can get elected. In New Hampshire, anybody can actually run for office and get elected. It is super easy to be in state for two years to run for state house. But what I mean by anybody is anybody who's met the qualifications. Anybody who can file for office in New Hampshire has a chance of actually winning that election.
Yeah.
You can win an election for state rep in New Hampshire with a $500 campaign budget.
Yeah, the fact is that 49 states have a lawyer industrial complex, which has taken over their state capital because the lazy lawyers who are bad at their job want to get paid to sit around and be politicians. In New Hampshire, it's $100 a year is what they get paid. So we don't have a lawyer industrial complex. We have regular citizens, many times retired.
More coming up about the Bureau of Land Management demands on Burning Man 2015. We'll give you the details, and you can bring up anything you want here on Free Talk Live. More on the way.
You know what rubs millions of people the wrong way? Their thighs.
Shaq talks Gold Bond Friction Defense.
Skin friction is quite an affliction on your legs, arms, whether you're running a 5K or just running upstairs.
And Gold Bond Friction Defense is
soothing.
Indeed. It's non-greasy, moisturizes, and helps like nobody's business.
Because your thighs rubbing together is nobody's business.
Gold Bond Friction Defense. Defense starts now.
Your thighs will thank you.
Oh, boy.
They say life is about choices. So let me introduce you to one of the best choices you can make in life. Grainger Choice. The Grainger Choice product line has just about everything we need to keep this place running. From batteries to V-belts, safety to sump pumps. And with Grainger Choice, we can trust that every product is dependable and cost-effective. When it comes to making life choices, here's a great one. Grainger Choice. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/choice or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the White Mountains of New Hampshire, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, June 28, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,176 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $251. Antiwar.com reports with the latest reports out of the UN saying some 80% of the Yemeni population is now in need of humanitarian aid. Saudi warplanes continued to pound the country, and Saudi warships continue to enforce a blockade through which only a handful of ships have been allowed, delivering a pittance of the aid needed. One would think this would add a new sense of urgency to ending the ongoing Saudi war against Yemen, but this apparently is not the case, with the pro-Saudi faction, the remnants of the former Hadi government, rejecting the idea of not even having a new peace talk at all. The last round of peace talks with the Shiite Houthis ended last week rather unceremoniously when Hadi negotiators attacked a Houthi press conference in Geneva, throwing shoes at the speakers and starting a fist fight. According to the UN, that was the only time during the entire week that the two sides were even in the same room. President Hadi resigned in January, and the Saudis insist on reinstalling him with this ongoing war. Hadi's aides insisted that there was nothing to talk about until the Houthis, who control most of the country, are prepared to unilaterally surrender all the major cities to them. That tactic is risky. Hadi was never a particularly popular ruler installed at the behest of the U.S. and Saudi officials in a single candidate vote. That his faction is seen opposing the peace talks and backing a bloody Saudi war that's killed thousands is likely to add to resentment against him.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports a video of an altercation between a SEPTA police officer trying to arrest a man carrying his young daughter for allegedly evading paying the $2.25 subway fare has gone viral. According to NBC Philadelphia, a cashier notified transit police about the fare after Ella Smith entered the Market Frankfurt L at the Margaret Orthodox station on Thursday. The video, captured by transit authority cameras, showed the officer forcefully shoving Smith by the throat while he held his toddler. During a press conference on Thursday, Police Chief Thomas Nestle III said an internal investigation is underway and that his department does not teach people to do that. According to Nestle, William Crawford, the officer involved, feared disciplinary action if he walked away. The officer's supervisor said, "That's a failure on my part. We never want a child's safety to be jeopardized." Nestle said Smith declined to give identification and refused to leave the train. The video shows Crawford speaking with Smith for around 6 minutes before physical force was used. After backup officers arrived, he was handcuffed while still holding his child, who appeared to be between 1 and 2 years old. Another passenger held the child while he was arrested. Smith was charged with fare evasion, disorderly conduct, and resisting arrest, and the child was placed into the care of her mother.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Greek lawmakers on Sunday authorized a proposed July 5th ballot referendum that came from Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras, which sets Greece on a course for a plebiscite that has enraged international creditors and increased Greece's chance of exiting the eurozone. The government easily passed the 151-vote threshold needed to authorize the referendum, with deputies from the far-right Golden Dawn voting with the government and pro-European opposition parties New Democracy, PASOK, and Topotomi, and the KKE Communist Party voting against. Greeks are due to vote on whether to accept or reject the latest terms offered by the creditors to Athens in order to unlock billions of euros in bailout funds. European partners have reacted negatively to the announcement of the referendum. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A report published this week found that a growing number of Americans are being forced to make ends meet by collaborating on songs with Miami-based rapper Pitbull. Citing rising income inequality and a turbulent job market, the report found many U.S. citizens moonlighting as recording artists, mixing drum beats, and guest starring on tracks for the Latin American producer.
It's exhausting. Between being part of Pitbull's entourage anytime he's on a club tour and mixing new hooks for him every few nights, I barely see my wife anymore. It's not like I want to do another remix with Avicii, but we really need the money. Okay, sure. I need to get back to work.
In a groundbreaking find, paleontologists this week unearthed the earliest known dinosaur stickers on record. Reportedly discovered in a box labeled Greg's Room, the excavated remains of the reptile adhesives include such stunning specimens as a triceratops featuring the words Dino's Rock, an Apatosaurus sticker, and the extremely rare puffy kind.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to join us here on the Live Sunday edition, whether you want to talk about Bitcoin, the run on the banks in Greece, or politicians. Actually, the Bureau of Land Management has some ridiculous demands for their politicians, the people that they're muckety-mucks, the high-end bureaucrats who will be coming to the festival that is thrown every year in the Black Rock Desert of Nevada. That would be, of course, Burning Man.
Now, so these aren't just cops that are coming there to sort of watch things to make sure they're fine. This is government officials. They're like, oh, let's go to Burning Man on the taxpayer's dime.
Well, they're described as high-level government officials in the story from the Reno Gazette Journal as featured in USA Today.
Okay.
So I don't know who that entails. They're not giving a list of names. They're just giving a list of demands to the Burning Man organizers.
Okay.
Those of you who don't know, Burning Man is in a... I've never been, but I have friends who've gone. And I've seen the pictures or seen the videos, and we've taken calls from people who've attended, and It just sounds like an amazing art festival that gets put together in the middle of the Black Rock Desert. It, last I heard, was attracting 70,000 attendees.
That's
this
huge.
Is the third largest city in Nevada while it exists, right, from what I heard.
That's a heck of a thing to say, right?
Yeah. I mean, and it comes together for a one-week time frame, right, and then it disappears. And it's an amazing thing. There's really a lot to appreciate about the Burning Man Festival. But one of the things that I think was a huge mistake on the part of the organizers was to put this thing on government land.
Yeah.
Bureau of Land Management controls the land.
They've lost all control. If they ever had any control, they've lost it, right?
And right. The fees, of course, have been going up and up and up. Now the bureaucrats from the BLM are demanding a $1 million VIP compound, which will bring the permit fee costs on the organizers just to throw just the fees just to have this party at this place, $5 million is what they're talking about. And then add to that whatever the other costs are of actually throwing the party. So that's the permit fees are $5
million. $5 million for permits.
The renderings of the compound, they...
It would have had to have been better on private property, right?
Of course. They show various accommodations set aside for VIP visitors, but don't indicate who those visiting dignitaries will be. There's a long list of food items that they're demanding. There's actually a link to the list of the items. The article over at USA Today only focuses on a handful, but the actual full list is exhaustive. In its level of detail, there are meal suggestions, mandatory items for a 24-hour service bar, hot meals between scheduled meal hours, scheduled meals, mandatory items for breakfast, mandatory items for hot lunch and dinners. I mean, I can go into more detail here, but it's insane.
What this is they're acting like superstars. And yep. The fact is the organizers of Burning Man really made them superstars when they had it on their property. They gave their festival to the federal government by having it on their property. And they need to... I guess they still own their festival, right? And they need to switch it over to some private property.
Now, it's arguable the federal government doesn't really own anything because all of what it has is stolen property.
Yeah, that's true.
Certainly arguable.
Of course, ownership...
Effectively, though.
A good portion of ownership is possession, right? And the federal government does effectively possess these lands. And if you go there without their permission slip, they will send men with guns out there to remove you, right? So they believe they own the property and they will act as though that they do. This from the USA Today story, the request is unprecedented in Burning Man's history, and it has turned into a point of contention as organizers negotiate with the agency for their annual permit to stage the event in the Black Rock Desert. No permit has been issued for this year's event, which runs August 30th to September 7th. Typically, permits are issued in early August, so I guess it's not as last minute as I thought it was. They usually run it right up to the wire,
okay,
getting this permit. Burning Man has refused to comply with the BLM's request, which the agency submitted June 1st, according to their spokesman Jim Graham. Quote, "We want to work this out. We're getting close to the event, but we feel that there are more common sense and cost-effective solutions," said the spokesperson. Burning Man declined to comment on whether its refusal to comply with the request would interfere with the permit's approval. And the BLM has said it needs the elaborate encampment to support staff at the event.
Management.
The agency is raising concerns about safety after a woman was run over and killed by a vehicle last year and says the additional staff will attend to assess security conditions. As though having 50 more BLM employees on site is somehow going to prevent someone from getting hit by an art car.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Somehow the management of the BLM is somehow going to prevent that.
When in history have having more cop type people, having more of them made it safer? Aren't you you're 8 times more likely to be killed by a cop than a terrorist, right?
I don't know if it's 8 times, but
wasn't
that
the BLM people that shot up those Indians who were rebelling at Wounded Knee 2 in the 70s?
It could very well be. The BLM says it needs the elaborate encampment to support its staff. Among the amenities included in the request are flushing toilets to be cleaned daily by Burning Man staff.
Yeah, come out and clean our toilets.
A laundry with washers and dryers, on-demand hot water, air conditioning, vanity mirrors, refrigerators, and couches.
Even as King Mark I, I do not demand that people come and clean my toilet.
Every day.
This is how ridiculous it is. This is how ridiculous it is. These people don't even claim to be your king, and they still claim that you should rule you.
The event, known for its emphasis on self-reliance in harsh conditions, provides only basic amenities such as non-flushable portable toilets for ticketed attendees. BLM officials contend their staff can no longer stay in the primitive accommodations available in Gerlach, Nevada, which is about 20 minutes from the event location.
Then they should just bring in some... come on. Are you telling me that the Department of Land Management can't contract with some other government agency to drop off some living quarters? Let's talk to the Air Force, ladies and gentlemen. They've got all kinds of this equipment. They can just drop things off. Talk to the Marines, all you're going to do is get tents. But if you talk to the Air Force, you're going to get something you can live in.
Yeah, but they can get... if they ask, they'll probably receive something, right? Say, look, these are the terms.
Where are our little chocolate tacos?
Yeah, a choco taco, yeah.
That's what they demanded. Seriously, they said, you must clean our toilets and bring us little chocolate tacos. It's great. Please continue to serve these people like this, because at some point or another, it will be too outrageous for every American.
They say they cannot stay in the primitive accommodations in Gerlach, Nevada. Quote, we're very concerned about where we put people that are part of our staff and that are part of the support and permitting, said Gene Seiditz.
I'm very concerned about where they put them, too.
BLM Winnemucca District Manager. It's safe to say that if you are working 14 to 16 hours a day in whiteout conditions on the hot playa, you don't want them to be unrested. Safety, security.
So this is for everybody. Choco tacos for the lowest of government bureaucrats.
But only the government bureaucrats, not everybody on the playa. Safety, security, and health is paramount. That I will not forego, says the district manager for the BLM. So apparently the event here has been going for, what, 2 decades? Maybe more than 2 decades? I think it was actually the mid-1980s, if I'm recalling correctly. Uh-huh. I'm sure there's a burner out there who could probably tell us offhand what how long this has been going for. But I feel like it's been since, like, 84 or something like that.
I don't know. It's been some time.
It's been a long time. Apparently, it's been totally fine up until now for whatever government bureaucrats who've been involved in this. But now they need frozen treats. And they need not just Choco Tacos. I've got the full list here.
86.
There's a whole ice cream category. There's drumstick. You know, the little drumsticks. With
yes.
The, Choco Taco.
I mean, cops aren't known for being pudgy.
Individual served ice cream, assorted flavors, popsicles, and ice cream sandwiches. So
it's hot out here. Yeah. I need an ice cream sandwich. A little dairy to get my throat gummed up.
Part of Burning Man's philosophy, Senate Minority Leader Harry Reid sent a letter to the Secretary of Interior following the investigation saying that, quote, providing outlandish, unnecessary facilities for the BLM and its guests should be beyond the scope of the permitting requirements. It makes me wonder if this is a play by the BLM to try to scare Burning Man away.
From doing BlackRock?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you think they want the money, right? I mean, they're talking about $5 million worth of permitting fees. Uh-huh. This is $1 million. So it was $4 million worth of fees and then $1 million in this VIP, whatever you want to call this, mansion. This temporary mansion that's going to be set up if they go through with this. They must want the fees. I mean, they must want this. Or is this some sort of way
maybe it's a negotiation tactic. I just don't know.
We'll come back with more here in moments about this ridiculousness. And if you know more about Burning Man, if you've been there, you got some opinions you want to share, if you're a burner, get on the lines at 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear. A life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market. The gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and we're here to take your calls about anything that happens to be on your mind. There's an update on the Greek situation. Guess what? Monday is going to be a bank holiday. That's good news, right? Holidays. Everybody likes holidays.
Everybody likes holidays.
That's actually not good news.
No.
Right? That's a sign of desperation. That is the bank saying, oh, crap. We know there's going to be people lined up come Monday morning at 7 a.m. or whenever the heck the banks open in Greece, 8 a.m., 9 a.m., and we do not want to deal with them. So let's just call a bank holiday until we can figure out what the heck to do next with this financial severe circumstances going on there. We can tell you more about that here in a little bit. It's Ian, Ridley, and Mark in the studio with you tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're in the middle of a silly list of demands by the Bureau of Land Management against the folks who are organizing Burning Man, and I did pull up the Wikipedia story. It started in 1986, and it's been in the Black Rock Desert since 1990. It actually originally was on Baker Beach in San Francisco. Was obviously a much smaller event back then, but you know, this thing's been going on for not quite 30 years, and now the Bureau of Land Management is demanding a VIP $1 million compound to be constructed with flushable toilets, which of course no one has at Burning Man unless you're in an RV. And you know, this is a desert. There's just desert winds blowing everywhere. It's hard to even keep your tent nailed. You've got to bring rebar out to Burning Man and shove that thing, you know, shove rebar into the ground, basically, to be able to tie your tent down so it doesn't blow away. This is some of the most severe conditions you could possibly imagine camping in. And these government bureaucrats want some sort of palace to be constructed for them out
well,
in this.
I can see their point, right? Like they're, and I'm not saying I agree with it. Their point is like, look, we must come out and protect these people from themselves.
Some woman got hit by an art car, apparently.
Yeah, some woman got hit by a car. Dear God. I mean, you know, how many people have gotten hit by vehicles when police have been in the media vicinity? I mean, it doesn't stop people from getting hit by vehicles. Sometimes it causes it. Being an emergency service person myself, I'm a fireman. I can say that there have been accidents right next to accidents I'm working. And I suspect the reason is because we've got bright, flashy red lights that draw people's attention to the accident because there's rubberneckers, because they're looking around. So emergency personnel don't stop accidents necessarily. That's their, if that's their saying. I mean, like, I can see there's been a rape and we have to investigate. There's a, you know, there are on average, I mean, you say it's the largest city in, third largest city in Nevada for like 1 week a year. And so I would say on average, there's probably, I don't know, two or three sexual assaults in that period of time. And I can see what the police would say, look, we have to investigate these things. And if we're going to investigate them, we need quarters to do it. And we didn't decide we wanted to come out and, you know, crap in porta potties in the desert.
Let's go to the phones. You can bring up anything you want. More on the BLM ridiculous demands here in a moment. But first, Doug is on the line in North Dakota, listening to KTGO in Newtown. Hey, Doug.
Hey, guys. So we're just walking through and stepping over into a beautiful new age of noncompliance. And I want to thank you guys for your work. I've been listening to you since 2011, since I've been up here in North Dakota and been able to listen to you.
Excellent.
And the beauty part about it is I don't have to agree with everything you say, but I support 100% your right to say it.
Nobody agrees with
Burning
us 100%.
Right on. Yeah, that was just a throwaway. Burning Man, I've never been there, but I, like you guys, I know people who have been. I've watched videos, some of the amazing arc structures that they build and the architectural beauty of it. And then at the end, they just burn it down.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just an icon to the... It's just a statement. It's just a silly pretense of the government to come in and say that they're going to do this. On the West Coast or on the East Coast, we just recently found out that only 5% of the people who are legally required to register their firearms in New York have done it. So that leaves 95% non-compliant.
Wow, that's great news.
This is what I've heard. It's subject to, you can vet it out, but this is the number that has been thrown out there by reputable sources.
Now, yeah, isn't there a serious penalty behind not complying? I mean, what are they threatening people with? Do you know?
It's a felony.
Yeah, that's pretty serious.
Yeah. So when you have 95% of an entire state who are say, I politely decline to participate in your egregious overstep of my right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of, you know, self-defense or however you want to, whatever nomenclature you want to use, that is a huge threshold that we have popped over. There's a lot of bad stuff going on, but I don't want people to dwell on that. I just want to imagine this. What if they gave a police state and nobody came?
I like the way you think, Doug. Anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
No, that's it. I just wanted to tell you guys to keep on keeping on. And occasionally, this is like the third time I've called in 4 years, so I'm not a serial caller. But, you know, I just like to occasionally call and say, you go, guys.
Thanks, Doug. So, appreciate it. We will. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We saw a little noncompliance this week at the Porcupine Freedom Festival, of course, with vendors who are serving food there, many of them not complying with any kind of government permits. They were not going and begging the government for some sort of health code permit. They were not going and paying sales tax to the government. The government even tried to send a couple of enforcers out to enforce the sales tax ordinance or statutes or whatever, and they were run off of the private property by the private property owner and the people who were there, including myself and probably more than a dozen attendees who surrounded these men and basically shouted them out.
I support that. I really do. I just wonder if you get to a level that Burning Man's at. How many people? 70,000, you said?
Yeah, that's what I heard last.
The Free State Projects event here, Porcupine Freedom Festival, maybe had 1,350 people or something like that.
Correct. It was 65,922 at Burning Man in 2014.
Right. So we're talking an incredible disparity in numbers. It's
sure.
More than 10 times the size. And I wonder, like, I don't think that Porkfest, tore it to get that large, could keep out the depredations of the state. I just don't think it's possible. I mean,
well, Porkfest will never get that large. It's not possible for, at least at this time, the property that the Porkfest,
right, you're just looking at the property
being held on is, you know, you can only fit 3,000 to 4,000 people
there.
New
Hampshire's
max.
A big state, my friend, and Porkfest could absolutely potentially get that large.
Someone would need to actually have a new site to locate it at. We're currently at the largest campground in the state of New Hampshire, and you can't hold Porkfest outside of New Hampshire. So you'd have to have somebody with some serious capital would have to find some new property that would be able to hold more than 5,000 people.
Yeah,
they would. As of right now, Porkfest seems to have sort of leveled out. It had 1,500 people last year and 1,300 this year.
You're making a prediction based on one set of numbers. I mean,
there was about 1,500 the year prior to that as well. So we've been sort of leveled for a few years. That doesn't mean it won't explode next year. I don't know. 855 453. We'll continue with more about the BLM's demands in moments. Free Talk Live.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live here on the live Sunday edition of the program. Back in our studios in Keene, New Hampshire, and joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
Dave Ridley's here, courtesy of his website, which is ridleyreport.com. You want a window to the world of just some of the activism happening here in New Hampshire, because Dave, unfortunately, cannot be everywhere at once, as much as I would like him to be. He can only be in one place at one time, and so you only get a fraction of what all is happening here, because there's a lot going on in New Hampshire. But Dave's got a great perspective on it. He's been here a long time as part of the Free State Project. So if you want to catch up with some of what's been going on, go to ridleyreport.com for a window into Dave Ridley's wacky, zany world.
Oh, yeah, right. Sorry, yeah. I forgot my cue. Don't get mad, get video. Go to ridleyreport.com. That's trademarked.
You should do that.
Hannah Hoffman has copyright on that.
BLM, the Bureau of Land Management, their demands are absolutely ludicrous on the folks organizing this year's Burning Man Festival. The festival's been going on for almost 30 years at this point. And will this be the nail in the coffin, the final nail in the coffin? Or will they, as far as it being on the Bureau of Land Management lands, will this finally give the organizers of Burning Man the incentive to pull the trigger on finding somebody with enough private property to host this this incredible event?
It's a diva government.
That's really
it. Tortures people.
Yeah, that's really exactly what we're talking about here. They're demanding all kinds of ridiculous things. They want, of course, pre-moistened towelettes, condiments, fruit, factory-wrapped or resealable individually wrapped snacks. I can get even more detailed here.
It's another reason why we need them out of New Hampshire. We need to kick all this land that the Federals own, like in the White Mountains. They need to be kicked out.
Snack varieties, including candy bars, bag candy, trail mix, cookies, brownies, granola bars, energy bars. This is what they want in their $1 million VIP facility that they want the Burning Man folks to construct for them on the playa there in Black Rock
Desert.
There's
some reason they can't just extort them for $1 million? Why do they have to make them do all the work, too? You know,
that's why I think they might be doing this to try to drive them away.
Isn't the licensing like $5 million already?
It was like $4 million, and this is going to make it $5 million worth. They want pretzels, shelled nuts, factory-packaged meats such as dried meat, sausage, pepperoni, jerky, etc. are acceptable. Processed cheese and cheese food products are allowed for this item only. The government retains its full right to reject any product offered under this paragraph if the quality of the product is rejected by users. For a variety, two different products shall be used each day. And that was just under that. The whole paragraph was just under the segment for snack varieties. Don't forget they also want milk alternative. Tea, including black, herbal, green, and spiced. Flavored tea may be served in addition to regular tea at the contractor's option. Dessert, including cakes, cookies, pies, cobblers, puddings, pastries, or ice cream. Can you imagine all these poor people in the Black Rock Desert just kind of subsisting on, you know, canned food or whatever the heck else they brought out there, rice and beans.
Trying to soak lentils for 24 hours and then crunching their way through them at that point.
And everybody knows, word's going to get around fast that the government bureaucrats are sitting in this palace over there with every possible food known to man.
I'd love to see it. I'd love to see the socialists versus these palace governments and let them duke it out. I mean, this reminds me of that scandal. Wasn't there like some judge somewhere that like she was forcing her bailiffs to give her back rubs and foot massages and stuff like that?
The reason this is a smaller scandal
is because there's no one person that they can lay it at the feet of, right? It was like Saul Alinsky said, when you have if you're focused on like a widespread abuse, no one really gets any attention. But if you focus on an individual, people hurt first. So you go after individuals rather than incidents or institutions. That's what he said. I technically that's opposite of my philosophy, but I'm starting to see his point.
Details of the request were included in an email exchange obtained by the Reno Gazette Journal between a Burning Man official and Bob Abbey, the former BLM director who is now a consultant for Burning Man organizers. He said, quote, having been a career BLM employee, I expect agency employees to behave competently and professionally in their interactions with the public. I don't see these traits being applied in their dealings with Black Rock City. So that's a former BLM agent saying that. BLM Special Agent Dan Love of Salt Lake City was cited multiple times as the person behind many of the requests. According to the emails, he did not return requests for comment. Love also led the BLM operation against Nevada rancher Cliven Bundy that ended in a standoff with Bundy's armed supporters. The VIP encampment called the Blue Pit is a new request this year. It's in addition to the more bare-bones accommodations for the employees will be staying at the BLM headquarters, which houses up to 150 working staff during the main event. The headquarters are also expected to have trailers with flushable toilets and sinks, though no showers or washers and dryers. Wait, though no showers or washers and dryers are requested. The headquarters will be located at the end of the 12-mile Playa Entity Road, or Entry Road, 12 miles north of Gerlach. The Blue Pit compound is about 2 miles past the Playa near an old gravel pit. So just to be clear, there's the VIP encampment, which does want the washers, dryers, and the flushable toilets. And then there's the headquarters, which has flushable toilets and sinks, but not the showers with the washers and the dryers.
Okay.
Who are the VIPs? Asks USA Today. While one map names some of the government officials who will be staying at the compound, it does not name the dozen or so VIPs. In past years, visiting government officials have stayed in Gerlach or at the BLM barracks nearby. Most of the VIPs will be state and federal officials for the BLM who are concerned with the safety and security of Burning Man. Based on a BLM assessment of the 2014 event, the boss man said over there, the assessment includes a critical review of the handling of Alicia Louise Cipiccio's death during the 2014 event. Cipiccio, who was 29, was hit by a vehicle during the early morning hours of August 28th. Burning Man and BLM officials traveled to D.C. in April to discuss officials' concerns and also Burning Man's proposed growth to a 100,000-person event in the future. About 70,000 are expected to attend this year. Look, if you put 70,000 people in a place for a period of time, somebody's going to end up hurt.
Yeah.
Somebody's going to die. After 30 years, I mean, it wasn't 70,000 in the first decade or two decades, but
we're just talking about statistics here, folks.
Right. Over time, you put thousands of people in one place, someone's going to have a heart attack. Someone's going to get hit by a car. And one of those people who get hit by a car may be a fatal accident.
I'd like to point out, when if you think right now you've sort of thrown up your hands, look, the cops have got to be there anyway, right? Well, think about this for a second.
Yeah, we're not talking about cops. We're talking about BLM bureaucrats.
Well, that's, but I mean, the Bureau of Land Management's going there to essentially be cops, right?
I'm not really sure. These VIPs aren't going to be out and about in the streets.
Well, ultimately, every member of every government is a cop.
The cruise ships manage to go every day. There are cruise ships leaving the United States, and they have not a single cop aboard. Do they have their own personal security? Yes, they do.
Yes, they do.
They have their own private security. But they float about in international waters with people who have paid to be there, and they do just fine. People die on cruise ships. It happens. People get sick on cruise ships. It happens. You don't need cops to handle it, and you certainly don't need $1 million complex full of choco pies for them.
We're going to continue the discussion here in a moment. I want to tell you about ProXPN. If you have internet, and you probably do if you're listening to the sound of my voice, then you need to protect yourself with your internet connection, because right now it's probably the case that your ISP, your internet service provider, is logging all the websites that you visit. They're probably also logging the search terms that you enter. And then, of course, they can data mine that information, sell it to other companies. They can give it away to governments to investigate you for who knows what. You can stop that prying and spying by signing up for ProXPN. They've got an app that you can download for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux. And once you get set up and connected through ProXPN, your internet connection is encrypted. It's a global virtual private network. That encryption protects you from these people that want to know your business. And that can include people who just want to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets to steal your passwords. So go and get ProXPN, proxpn.com/FTL. It's easy to get set up, and then it's easy to upgrade to the premium level account, which gets you unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. And you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Go and use our discount code to save 50%, which, by the way, saves you 50% from the regular monthly price when you buy the annual account. The code is FTL50, and it's good for the lifetime of your account. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off. Use promo code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. More about the Bureau of Land Management's demands on Burning Man, the amazing festival in the Black Rock Desert of Nevada. Will it happen this year? I'd say it's in question. Free Talk Live, more coming up. You can share your thoughts.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
You, Me, and BTC is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
We're sitting down with Mr. Jason King. If you want to f*** with the government, feed homeless people, man.
Jeffrey Tucker.
What's possible in the Bitcoin space? It sounds a little like science fiction, but if you wait enough time, it becomes a reality.
Angela Keaton from antiwar.com.
This is what the United States does, involves killer robots. For Bitcoiners, this is a way to get around that.
Subscribe at youmeandbtc.com.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Ridley.
And King Mark the First.
Oh, you're not wearing your crown tonight for the first time in a long time, Mark. You've been wearing that crown nightly at the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
You know, I'm getting, for one, a crown does not make a king. You know, a king is king whether he has a crown on or not. But I'm ordering a new crown.
Why?
Why? I need a plush one because it's uncomfortable underneath the headphones.
You need a $1 million crown. So we're going to get into a little
bit more. I've never demanded that anyone buy a crown for me.
No, that's true. You're buying your own crown. Very good. So we can talk a little bit more about the BLM. I've got the interesting statistics about how much they've been paying in fees. They've been going up, shooting up. The folks from Burning Man have been paying ridiculous fees to the Bureau of Land Management over the last few years. And we can talk about that. The Burning Man Festival in question as to whether or not they're going to get the permit this year after the BLM is demanding a $1 million fancy facility, a VIP facility, a compound to be built on the playa there in the Black Rock Desert in Nevada this year for Burning Man, which is coming up the end of August. But first, to the phones and your thoughts. Ralph is in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Ralph.
Yeah, thank you for taking my call, guys. You know, this week, as you know, Obama showed up there in South Carolina.
I suspect in some way or another, he sullied the name of the United States.
You know, as long as he just called it quits, he would be an issue for me, okay? But the issue raised is once again being injected into the national dialogue by this man, okay, by agitating us or inflaming a situation that's already been, under control by the governor there who has, taken the company.
Dave, you look really frustrated with
boring.
This caller.
You know, let me say this. Race relation under
Dave
this
says
man,
you're
Obama
boring, Ralph.
Boring.
What do you have to say what do you have to say to that?
To say to what?
Dave says you're boring. Dave Ridley is bored by your
perhaps
call.
It's a bored topic.
Same old.
We are too cowardly to talk about the issue of race. Why is that? No, your side is too cowardly to talk about the issue of race.
Oh, I'll be happy to talk
to
you about race.
We need to talk about the same old things over and
I can't understand him, Dave. Hang on. Let's give him a chance. Now, are you going to rant about Obama? I mean, it seems like that's all you ever call about.
That's the purpose of this call. Talk about Obama.
Don't you have anything else that's interesting?
Look, Ian, you call it Free Talk Live, and you ask people if they'll call in about anything
they
want.
And you can call about anything you want, but when it's the same call over and over again, I mean, I'm going to get tired of it, too.
Well,
and
David is in here a night. State
why
today.
Why is it hard for you to deal with the issue of race when this man is forcing it every day on you?
Well, I think
he's not forcing anything on me. I don't pay any attention to him.
When it comes to the topic of race, I tend to agree that, that there's the conversation surrounding race is messed up.
Is race relation under Obama better or good?
Is what?
Is race relation under this man Obama better or good?
Better or worse? I'd say that that race relations have generally been getting better.
I don't even know what that means. I mean, what does that even mean?
Right now, the nation is blowing up over the conversation of race, is what he's pointing at.
There were some black people and some Indian people at Porkfest, and I got along fine with them. So it seems like race relations are just fine in my world.
If things are fine in your world, then everything's fine?
Well, what does it mean to say, how are race relations today? I mean, that's some general collectivist statement. It means nothing.
It's about things in the United States, and Obama is the president of the United States. I think that there's something to be said here, but
there's something to be said about what?
Okay, so I think that we need to be talking
about
conclusion about race, but I think that you blame everything on Obama, and it's kind of boring, Ralph.
You're damn right. It is. Everything is blamed on him.
It's
no plan in dealing with ISIS, and God forbid we would be
George W. Bush were still in charge of America.
Whatever your name is, I forget.
Ralph.
You are like a product of this system that is designed to get us to talk about irrelevant things. And you have become like an irrelevant thing machine. All you want to do is talk about this 2% of stuff that doesn't matter while huge, important things are happening.
What 2% stuff? What is the 2% stuff you're talking about?
Yeah, they want you to talk about Obama versus whoever else. That's what they want you to talk about.
Talking,
they don't want you to talk
I'm
about...
I'm talking specifically about the issue of race. This
they want you to talk... Oh, they really like it when you talk about that.
Yeah, there's no conclusion going to come about race. There's a Booker T. Washington quote out there, and I can't get it off the top of my head. But this is a guy from 100 years ago claiming that there are people out there that want to keep, you know, black people out there that want to keep alive the conversation around race because they make a living off of it.
And that's Obama. And that's Obama.
Thank you. Obama's got a job whether he keeps it alive or not. He's fine one way or the other.
He's going to make a viral YouTube video out of that guy.
I think what Obama wants to do is honestly solve the race issue in this country before he sort of leaves.
Who, Ralph or Barack Obama?
Barack Obama.
Well, he's not going to solve
the race
issue.
He's not going to solve it. No, it's not. But, I think the race issue has to be solved one individual at a time. Mm. Like, you have to solve the race issue for yourself. Right now, people are arguing about this rebel flag thing. And, you know, for me, I'm from the South. I think the Confederate flag is the most beautiful flag. When we're talking about flags, right, it's the most beautiful flag of all the flags. And to me, it doesn't necessarily mean racism. But I know that it does mean that to other people. So I would never put a sticker of that thing on my car because I would be afraid that I would hurt someone's feelings, and I'm not interested in doing that. So those are my thoughts on this flag, and actually there's people screaming at the Southerners screaming at their radios right now. Yes, I get that it's the Naval Jack or the Second Virginia Battle Flag or whatever it is that they've got flying in South Carolina.
It's not
Carolina.
The tobacco flag? I thought it was a tobacco flag.
What do you mean?
Like people have, you know, they have that flag and they spit tobacco.
See, that's just another northerner yik-yakking.
Actually, it's complicated. I'm not precisely a northerner natively.
But I agree that, if you find somebody who has that, you know, is flying that flag or has a sticker on the back of their car, they're likely to not be of the highest class. And, you know, what are you going to say about that? Maybe they pride themselves on that. In many cases, they do. They say redneck, not a high class statement.
Now you're not happy with the rebel flag, right? The fact that people have been flying it, and
me,
even though you're from the South,
I just wouldn't. But when I see it flying, it doesn't mean racism to me. I just think it's become a.
But weren't you mad about somebody having it at Pork Fest or something?
I would not be in a flag in
Who
a picture
cares?
With it, and I didn't know that they were going to it because it's happening in New Hampshire, and that's why I care.
I'm supposed to care if it happens in New Hampshire. I don't understand why you're
so butthurt over somebody flying it in a picture that you happen to be in. By the way, I'm looking at this picture and I don't see it. Are you
that's
talking about
I've
the
heard.
Big group photo?
Yeah, that's what I've heard, that it was in the picture.
I mean, it's a big picture. There's a lot going on here, but there's no rebel flag that's jumping out at me. You're pointing and I'm still not seeing it.
I can't see it because I can't see your screen because you have it at an angle.
Well,
so
I'm sorry.
You can play
solitaire while
I'm doing or whatever.
So what happens at the Porcupine Freedom Festival every year? There's a large group photo that happens on the field with something like 1,000 people or, you know, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people in it. And obviously
it appears to have been I guess there was a kerfuffle over it, and I guess they did get the guy to move it then.
Okay. Well, anybody can show up.
Did you not see the big giant rebel flag at Porkfest?
There was some guy riding around on a four-wheeler with a rebel flag.
And that was parked strategically to be in the picture, and I guess they asked him to move it.
Oh, okay. Well, and I guess he did move it then, because it's definitely not in that photo.
I'm glad I'm not in the picture.
Yeah, I mean, it is unfair if you think about it. Okay, maybe I do care. It's unfair if you think about it that the rebel flag, which represents a government which killed mostly soldiers briefly, is considered anathema, but the U.S. flag, which represents a government which has killed, you know, huge numbers of civilians, that's considered okay.
Well, tell you what, here's how you get up to 25% or more off of your favorite flag. Whatever flag you want, it's probably for sale at Amazon. You can pay with Bitcoin through purse.freetalklive.com and save big time. I just put a router on my purse account, and I'm going to try to get 33% off of this thing. You can try and get whatever percentage off you want off of your products on Amazon.
I figured the most unlikely flag I could find was the Cornish flag, and I typed it into Amazon, and there must be than a dozen dealers here, yeah.
Purse is the way to go. If you're going to shop at Amazon, why wouldn't you want to get 25% off? Or more, or less. You know, if you go with less, you'll get the item quicker. basically, the larger the percentage, the little, you know, the longer you'll likely have to wait for the order to be fulfilled. But man, this works. Go and get signed up through purse.freetalklive.com, and then we'll get a very small percentage of each purchase that you make. When you start through purse.freetalklive.com, hour number 3 is on the way. This is Free Talk Live.
It is the year 91001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, ZOG.ninja, code FTL.
I'm a carbon fiber 29er full suspension mountain bike. My owner and I are attached to the hip, literally. Or we were, until the apartment got robbed while he was at his vinyasa yoga class. And the burglar used me to make his getaway. My owner's gonna be uber bummed when he realizes I'm gone. I guess he'll have to find another way to get his daily dose of adrenaline. Maybe he can take up urban beekeeping.
Your stuff can't protect itself. That's why the Geico Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on renter's insurance. Renter's insurance will cover personal property loss or damage as well as provide liability protection. Visit geico.com today.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the White Mountains of New Hampshire, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, June 28, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,176 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $251. Antiwar.com reports with the latest reports out of the UN saying some 80% of the Yemeni population is now in need of humanitarian aid. Saudi warplanes continued to pound the country, and Saudi warships continue to enforce a blockade through which only a handful of ships have been allowed, delivering a pittance of the aid needed. One would think this would add a new sense of urgency to ending the ongoing Saudi war against Yemen, but this apparently is not the case, with the pro-Saudi faction, the remnants of the former Hadi government, rejecting the idea of not even having a new peace talk at all. The last round of peace talks with the Shiite Houthis ended last week rather unceremoniously when Hadi negotiators attacked a Houthi press conference in Geneva, throwing shoes at the speakers and starting a fist fight. According to the UN, that was the only time during the entire week that the two sides were even in the same room. President Hadi resigned in January, and the Saudis insist on reinstalling him with this ongoing war. Hadi's aides insisted that there was nothing to talk about until the Houthis, who control most of the country, are prepared to unilaterally surrender all the major cities to them. That tactic is risky. Hadi was never a particularly popular ruler installed at the behest of the U.S. and Saudi officials in a single candidate vote. That his faction is seen opposing the peace talks and backing a bloody Saudi war that's killed thousands is likely to add to resentment against him.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports a video of an altercation between a SEPTA police officer trying to arrest a man carrying his young daughter for allegedly evading paying the $2.25 subway fare has gone viral. According to NBC Philadelphia, a cashier notified transit police about the fare after Ella Smith entered the Market Frankfurt L at the Margaret Orthodox station on Thursday. The video, captured by transit authority cameras, showed the officer forcefully shoving Smith by the throat while he held his toddler. During a press conference on Thursday, Police Chief Thomas Nestle III said an internal investigation is underway and that his department does not teach people to do that. According to Nestle, William Crawford, the officer involved, feared disciplinary action if he walked away. The officer's supervisor said, "That's a failure on my part. We never want a child's safety to be jeopardized." Nestle said Smith declined to give identification and refused to leave the train. The video shows Crawford speaking with Smith for around 6 minutes before physical force was used. After backup officers arrived, he was handcuffed while still holding his child, who appeared to be between 1 and 2 years old. Another passenger held the child while he was arrested. Smith was charged with fare evasion, disorderly conduct, and resisting arrest, and the child was placed into the care of her mother.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Greek lawmakers on Sunday authorized a proposed July 5th ballot referendum that came from Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras, which sets Greece on a course for a plebiscite that has enraged international creditors and increased Greece's chance of exiting the eurozone. The government easily passed the 151-vote threshold needed to authorize the referendum, with deputies from the far-right Golden Dawn voting with the government and pro-European opposition parties New Democracy, PASOK, and Topotomi, and the KKE Communist Party voting against. Greeks are due to vote on whether to accept or reject the latest terms offered by the creditors to Athens in order to unlock billions of euros in bailout funds. European partners have reacted negatively to the announcement of the referendum. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Buying a burger might start taking a bite out of your wallet. Meat prices skyrocketed this week after the place that makes the meat revealed that the cow smashing machine is all beefed up.
This machine has beef way up in it. The basher, the meat collector, even the main meat hall, all of it. Lousy with beef.
The cow smashing machine is an integral part of the meat making process, taking whole big cows into one end with all different meats falling out the other. Supermarket chains warn that unless we start smashing cows again soon, we could face a serious beef shortage. The beef industry is working hard to unclog the cow smasher, but says it could take several days or even weeks to scoop all the beef that's crammed up in there. Until it's fixed, meat-hungry Americans can take solace in the fact that the chicken grinder is working at full capacity, just completely tearing up all those chickens, and the pig machine is porking out hardcore. Up next, bluesmen find a rising trend of their babies done leaving on that there old devil train.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to more Free Talk Live. We'll talk to you about anything you want to discuss here on the live Sunday edition of the program. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's even worse news coming out of Greece. We started the show out with the news that there's a run on the banks with people lining up at ATM machines across the country on Saturday. And then as of today, a newer announcement has been made, which is not good news. We'll explain that here in just a moment. But we've been talking about the Bureau of Land Management and their demands that they're making against the folks organizing Burning Man, the nearly 3-decades-long festival that's been going on out in the Black Rock Desert for the majority of the time. And the Black Rock Desert, unfortunately, is
well, claimed property by the U.S. federal government and the Bureau of Land Management, the very same bureaucracy that gave a hard time to Cliven Bundy, the rancher, the cattle rancher, last year or two years ago, whenever that happened.
Yeah.
So now they're messing with the folks running Burning Man, and they've been messing with them for a while. I've got the numbers here about what they've been charging in permit fees just to rent the playa, the portion of the desert on which Burning Man is built, this temporary community, this temporary city that springs up out of nothing in the middle of nowhere to exist for a week in time where people party real hard.
Well, it's art.
I mean, they put up a lot of art.
Yeah, the amazing part is that it exists for a moment in time.
Yeah.
And that to me is what's artistic about it.
Well, the art is fantastic as well. I don't know if you've seen any of the photos.
I've seen some interesting stuff, yeah.
Yeah, just some amazing larger than life kind of art installations that's built on site or trucked in, and they're just absolutely fantastic. To look at.
As eye-catching and egregious as this story is corruption, is as much corruption as it exposes in the government, ultimately it's just another story about more Americans who are completely incapable of defending themselves from the authorities, right? The more impotent Americans just lying down and being eaten by the monster and not doing, I have never heard of them doing anything in response. And, you compare that to Porkfest, where the instant there's even a rumor of a government person, there's a swarm of people. Then they had a suspected informant a few years ago, and he got, followed everywhere he went, and people confronted him with cameras. He was surrounded by a crowd, and the same thing happened to these bureaucrats that were out in the open. It reminds me of that Churchill quote. He said, "Still, if you will not fight when you can easily win without bloodshed. If you will not fight when your victory will be sure but not too costly, you may come to a moment when you will have to fight with all the odds against you and only a precarious chance of survival. There may be an even worse case. You may have to fight when there is no hope of victory because it is better to perish than live as slaves."
And that's what you get for waiting, right? You're waiting around for your opportunities to stand up for yourself, then it's too late.
Yeah, a lot of people will critique the activists here in New Hampshire for doing a liberty-oriented activism here when go someplace where the tyranny is terrible. Why don't you go to North Korea and do your activism?
Or New York City or whatever.
Well, because you would want to fight the small battle before it becomes the large one.
Yeah, exactly.
Not that I think the United States is right on the, on its path to being North Korea, but I think that it's on its path to being a very statist government, many of which it was fighting during the Cold War.
But I totally understand and agree with you, Dave Ridley, on this. I think that people do need to stand up for themselves and that you do need to stand up before it's too late, which is why I want to see more people move to New Hampshire sooner rather than later. The sooner we can get the ball rolling here on this Free State Project idea, the more effective we're going to be. The longer we wait, the more difficult it's going to be. But most people are scared. They're scared to stand up for themselves because they know that the first person who stands up is the one that's going to get their head bit off.
Here's another quote from Sun Tzu. Quote, "What the ancients called a clever fighter is one who not only wins, but excels in winning with ease. Hence, his victories bring him neither reputation for wisdom nor credit for courage," unquote. And that's exactly what the Free Staters do. They fight where they don't have to fight. They fight where it's a civic battle or a proverbial battle before it has to be fists and before it has to be firearms.
So a little background on Burning Man. This is from the USA Today story here. It began in 1986 as 20 friends gathered at the end of the summer on Baker Beach in San Francisco. They built a wooden figure and lit it at the end of a ceremony.
Wow, they're allowed to set things on fire in 1986 on the beach in San Francisco?
Well,
they did.
That's why they ended up leaving. The ritual moved to the Black Rock Desert in 1990 after park police wouldn't allow the fire and grew into a combination campout, performance venue, artist haven, and experiment in communal living, and greatly expanded during that decade. It's now a nonprofit organization committed to leaving no trace of its participants in between each year's event.
Well, it's a great thing to commit to, I think.
Burning Man would need more time to comply with the BLM's requests as is. So in case you're just tuning in, the Bureau of Land Management has demanded a $1 million VIP compound be built on the property for this year's Burning Man.
More time. They don't need more time. They need a time machine. And that's the next thing the BLM is going to be demanding.
Some of the staff are already preparing to go to the playa to begin setup for the event, even though they don't even have the permit yet. Burning Man would, let's see, BLM is asking for services and amenities that seem to be beyond what should be required to administer the permit, said one of their spokespeople.
It's beyond what should be required for brain surgery.
Well, I don't know what's required, but I can tell you that the budget has skyrocketed in the last few years.
I'm going to give you the numbers on that here in a moment. Their spokesman says every year it's an ongoing negotiation, and every year we reach an agreement and consensus, but these things were kind of big. Now, the bureaucrat for the government says that the BLM is willing to compromise on its list of requirements. He said Burning Man...
Can we compromise back to 2002?
And are they getting video of these negotations?
I doubt it, Dave, and that's a good idea.
Helpless lie-downs.
Yeah.
Bend-overs.
He said
What's happened to Americans?
He said Burning Man officials haven't outlined their issues with the request to him yet. Last year, Burning Man paid the BLM more than $4 million for the special recreation permit, which allows the event to have up to 70,000 people each year. The cost has gone up substantially over the last 4 years, despite the unchanged population cap. Here you go. In 2011, Burning Man paid $858,000 for that permit. In 2012, $1.4 million, nearly doubling from 1 year to the next, and then doubling again. In 2013, to $2.9 million. So 2014, it went to $4 million. Now, with this new VIP facility, this palace that they want, it's $5 million.
It might as well be a billion because they'll pay it.
They're feeding the torturers.
I did the math, by the way. For 70,000 attendees, that's more than $70 per attendee just for the fee to have the property. Now, that doesn't include the rest of the ticket price. Now, the last time I looked at Burning Man ticket prices, it was over $300, like $375 at least. And this was a few years ago that I looked at this. This was probably before these major ticket cost increases.
Imagine here. You could be the you could be the government, and you could get a certain amount of each ticket price of anything just by saying you need a license, you need a permit, you need you need to pay for our services, which is running cops around there and arresting your ticket holders.
Maybe I said this last time we were talking about this, but they're just like that main character in George Lucas's THX 1138 film, the one that came out right before Star Wars, mm-hmm. where the main character in the film, the hero, spends all his time building these robots, and toward the end of the film, he's running from the robots.
Yeah. So then, of course, you mentioned the cops, Mark. This was another problem with Burning Man in recent years, is the ever-increasing police presence on the playa, where the police are more threatening than they've ever been. They're making more arrests, than they have in the past. And it is not as friendly of an event that it has been known to be. Some people have been saying that the event has jumped the shark because of the more police. It's one of those things where the police keep demanding more of them to be paid
sure.
to be there as well.
Pretty soon it's going to be nothing but, a few artists setting, some wood on fire and the cops. Lots and lots of cops.
Are we
cops getting free showers and choco pies?
Are we blowing this out of proportion? And by the way, the cops may not be getting those things, Mark. It may be just the BLM VIPs who get it, not the average bureaucrats who are there. So that's pretty much the story. They're basically trying to, it sounds like they're trying to run them off, doesn't it? I mean, they're jacking the rates up 5 times in 5 years, going from less than $1 million to over $5 million per year. And with ridiculous requirements about having to have choco pies and drumstick and ice cream and, all kinds of things. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, the latest on Greece. There's going to be a bank holiday. You're excited, right? It's Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply Safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it, and that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to simplysafedefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's simplysafedefense.com.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Back now with more Free Talk Live on the Live Sunday edition, continuing here at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight in studio, you've got me, Ian
Ridley,
and King Mark the First.
You can get Bitcoin, and now might be a good time to do so. I can't predict the future, but we know that things are looking pretty bad in Greece. And the last time similar economic circumstances struck Cyprus, there was a big spike in the Bitcoin price. Now, the Bitcoin price has already gone up in the last 48 hours.
This is a tiny spike in comparison, isn't it?
True, but it went up from like $240 to $250 in the last 48 hours.
It's really amazing how much stability we've got now. I mean, back in the day, that would not have been considered newsworthy at all. But now, Bitcoin moves very gently compared to the old days.
Well, you never know what's going to happen tomorrow. I mean, that's the way it is now, but tomorrow could be a new day, and it could shoot up dramatically. I mean, who knows?
Eventually something will happen that will create panic buying and a dramatic rise in price, and everybody will be using them. And
well,
so
how about a bank holiday in Greece? I mean, things are not looking good there, with some major economic factors coming calling soon on the government of Greece, with a major debt load from 19 different
nations who would like to collect on the debt that they're owed, and there's payment issues, and of course the banks are now calling a bank holiday. That's the latest news. So there's a chance that Bitcoin's going to go up some more. Now, I don't know if it will. It could go down. You never know what's going to happen tomorrow. But if you want to get some Bitcoin, go to expresscoin.com. You can get it there fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just start off at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, if you're in Greece, sorry, you can't use ExpressCoin. But expresscoin.com, U.S. or Canada, go there now. You can grab their app if you want, or you can just use their website, expresscoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL. The latest from Greece, we actually started the show with a story about Greece and the ATM machines that are being, I guess, you know, constantly bombarded by the people in the country. There's photos of people lining up, several people, long lines of people at these ATMs. 500 out of 7,000 of them yesterday were out of money. They had run dry. And this is what people are trying to do on the weekend because, you know, bankers' hours, they're terrible. Most banks aren't open past Monday through Friday. I actually happen to have a bank here in the Northeast that's actually open 7 days a week, which is a miracle as far as I'm concerned. I got to give props to TD Bank for that one.
Yeah, that's certainly unusual.
And they actually stay open late, which is even more unusual. So,
okay,
but
good job, guys.
Your typical bank, they're closing up Friday and they reopen on Monday. So in the meantime, all you get's the ATM. And so that's what people are doing. They're making a run on the ATMs, and they would make a run on the banks tomorrow morning if they could. But the latest news from Athens at the Washington Post is that Greek leaders have planned to shutter their banks on Monday amid a last-ditch discussions about their nation's economic future as panicked citizens try to pull their money from their accounts while they're still able. Sunday's decision, that's today, to declare a bank holiday was a signal, so they're still having their meetings. These bankers are very concerned with business tomorrow, so they're in the office, but you can't go
there. They're busy. Yeah, they're just not going to open up and give you any money.
It's so simple for them, though. All they have to do is make sure the government keeps printing ones and zeros for them.
But they can't because they're using the euro.
Well, give them time.
Sunday's decision to declare a bank holiday is a signal that Greece's five-year battle to stay in the shared euro currency may swiftly be coming to an end. ATMs in Athens were running out of money and tensions were running high as Greeks stood in line for hours to scrape together petty cash for basic supplies.
It's like, with all these years, it hadn't occurred to them at some point, like, I don't know, 6 years ago that this was going to happen and to be ready for it. They waited until today to the weekend or whatever.
You know, people don't know what's happening around them. They only hear things.
Well, Greeks do. I mean, things do burn. Things have been burning in Greece. So they know they must see the fires.
I mean, it still wouldn't surprise me if people were oblivious.
Well, I don't know that they're oblivious, Ian. They're socialists. I mean, the fact is that they've been indoctrinated, Europe more so than the United States, but the United States plenty. They've been indoctrinated to believe Keynesian economics because that's what's convenient for the politicians. And they've been indoctrinated to believe that, well, people who have done well in life owe people who have not done so well.
It's not Keynesian. It's post-Keynesian, because a Keynesian is not near as bad as what's now. Because the Keynesian idea is that you spend during the good times.
Right.
I mean, you spend during the bad times and save during the good times.
Right.
Just spending all the time.
It's true. Well, I mean, if you ever so the Keynesians never did that, though. I mean, once you turn that power over to the government and say, you know, it's a good idea to spend during the bad times, they're never going to think there is a good time. When governments got rich, the local governments here in the United States got rich during the housing bubble. I remember what it was like in Manatee and Sarasota counties, where we're from, in Florida. They just kept on, oh my God, the coffers were getting so full.
Yeah, sure.
We don't have to change the millage, but people's property values are going up, so they're happy to pay in more money. Oh my God, let's build Olympic-sized pools for every school. Every child gets a laptop. You know what we need? We need a big, giant arch made of pure platinum and diamonds over the main street.
They literally did build one in a Missouri school district, Olympic-sized pool for the kids.
Yeah, I'm obviously exaggerating with the the giant diamond arch. But
that's because the economy crashed before they could get to that one.
That's what it came down to is that these politicians just saw all this money coming in and they would never thought it was going to end. They didn't take that money in their coffers and, you know, pay off bonds, you know, or anything like that. They didn't just hold it in reserve for the when times were tough. They said spend, 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 spend.
And those are the ones that didn't have a printing press.
Yeah, let's go to Alan. He's in Reno, Nevada, listening to KKFT. Hey, Alan.
Hey, hello.
Welcome. You're on the air.
Thank you. Hey, I just had a quick question about our comment, however you want to count it, about the BLM and the 50 employees.
Yes.
Who's going to watch them when they're out and about visiting the camps and doing their checks or whatever they have to do? What's going to stop them from stopping at, say, the sex tent and plating ice cream?
Well, not a damn thing is going to stop them from going to the sex tent.
When the Department of Minerals or whatever got caught doing cocaine off, like, hookers' butts on actual...
The oil rig?
Yeah, on oil rigs while doing their visits to check in on oil rigs.
Yeah.
At this point, a Department of Minerals?
I don't have exactly the right term, but the word
the
minerals...
The regulators, whoever the heck it is that's regulating those oil
rigs. I will get the name for you in just a second, but the story itself is true. I don't know that they actually did the cocaine off of the butts of the hookers, but they were found with hookers and cocaine.
Okay, and so my... I can add on to that question. One more, if you will.
Yes.
Will they be watched over by Homeland Security? And will Homeland Security also need their own million-dollar one-week vacation home?
Alan, you're giving them too many ideas. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Minerals Management Service.
But he's right. I mean, who watches the watchers? They usually hire another government bureaucracy to watch the watchers and hire another government bureaucracy to watch them, and then it never ends.
They changed their name because they got such a bad name for doing the coke off the cooker's bums.
Jesus.
What did they change it to? What did they change it to?
I wasn't ready for that.
And what was it originally? Mineral what?
Minerals Department Management Service.
The Bureau, MMS.
Yeah, Bureau of Ocean Energy Management and Regulation Enforcement.
That's what it is now.
Yeah. The NKVD changed its name too.
We'll come back with more in moments.
Is that the KGB?
Free Talk Live.
It was.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people. When the cleaners ruined some special clothing, all they could do was show us a sign that said they weren't responsible. But when they got the letter from one of our Legal Shield attorneys, he promptly gave us a check for $1,152. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
An alarming UN report on magical realism released this week warns of increased incidences of women's tears flooding the entire world. A UN committee linked the catastrophic phenomena to matronly widows, commonly named Tita and Esmeralda, who wept for up to 90 days on end about their estranged lovers.
Just consider how detrimental it is to a nation's workforces to have thousands of its plantation overseers simply disappear one night into the midsummer fog, only to return decades later without having aged a single day. Put simply, if such phenomena are not immediately halted, the effects on the international community will be catastrophic.
The nation's limo drivers spent a magical prom night playing scratch-off tickets in the parking lot this week. According to sources, chauffeurs nationwide began their enchanting evening by cramming swank magazines into their glove compartments before dropping off their students at a school gym, working through a stunning assortment of lotto cards, and dining upon a wide range of microwave-heated taquitos from a nearby 7-Eleven.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Now back with more Free Talk Live. You can dial in here and join us on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether you want to talk about Greece.
Really?
Ridley.
Oh, wait. It wasn't time for me to say my name. Yeah.
It's Ridley, Ian, and Mark here in the studio. Whether you want to talk about the situation in Greece where there's a bank holiday that's been declared for tomorrow, and as fun as that sounds, it's really not good news at all for the people in Greece, although it might be good news for people holding alternative currencies like Bitcoin. I guess we'll just have to stay tuned and see what happens there, but so far, the Greece crisis seems to have been good for Bitcoin. But whether you want to talk about that or the Bureau of Land Management, as our last caller just pointed out, the BLM with their ridiculous demands of $4 million in cash, basically, and then $1 million VIP compound to be created at the Black Rock Desert in Nevada for the Burning Man Festival. I think that he was onto something that, you know, these VIPs of the government, they're not there to do any governmental work. They're not there to have important meetings.
They're partying at Burning Man.
That's what you do at Burning Man. You either, you know, you're either there to work the security staff and, you know, try to help people who are having a bad trip, or you have a party. You know, you take care of some artwork, or you party and do artwork at the same time. And I've never been to Burning Man, but, you know, I've talked to some people who have, so I feel like I know a thing or two about it, but I don't think you can really know Burning Man unless you actually attend it. And it takes a level of dedication to attend this event. I mean, you have to truck in everything that you plan to use. You want water when you're at Burning Man? You better bring it. You've got to, you know, pack in gallons and gallons of water, like multiple gallons per day. I forget what the recommendation is per person per day, but I think it's at least two, if not more. I mean, there's a lot of...
It's heroic. These people are heroic, and that's what makes it so much more frustrating to see what pushovers they are when they're confronted by a bureaucrat.
But this is really all about the government bureaucrats being comfy at Burning Man so they can have a good time. Because I can tell you, if I were going to Burning Man, I sure as hell would prefer to have a $1 million VIP, hangout place to go with air conditioning and flushable toilets. I'd love to have that.
Who wouldn't?
You're dealing with what is essentially an arid desert that has absolutely nothing. There's not even, you know, any fresh water anywhere nearby. You know, the only kind of services you can buy out there is an RV cleanout service. There's nothing out there. You have to drive quite a distance to even get to whatever, you know, might resemble a general store in some nearby tiny town. And I don't know what the closest one is, but it's not that close to this location. So, you know, the people that go out there are hardcore into this. It takes a lot of dedication. I mean, I actually looked at it one year because my friend wanted to go, and, you know, I love the idea of it, but just the logistics of getting, you know, you'd have to rent, you know, you'd have to either like get all the camping equipment and then drive out there, which, of course, coming from New Hampshire, is you're talking about a week long trip just to get out to Nevada from here.
And a week long to get to Nevada from here? I mean, you just drive, man. It takes 3 days to get across the United States.
Okay. Well, I mean, I guess if you were to be taking your time and, you know, presuming things don't go wrong, as things can, you know, possibly do when you're on the road, I was looking at sort of, you know, kind of just calling it a week of driving, basically, if you were going to not drive straight through, if you're going to stop and sleep somewhere, for instance.
I would say that makes you something like an old woman, but I don't want to insult old women.
Yeah. Well, Mark, I can't say I've ever done a cross-country journey before with, you know, the amount of camping equipment that would be necessary to get there. But nonetheless, I've never driven that far. I mean, I've driven from Florida to New Hampshire, and that took 26
hours. With nearly no stops.
That took 26 hours straight, yeah. Well, that's because we were trading off. But like I said, I was presuming that we would be stopping and camping off at different places. Because when you're doing something like that, you kind of want to make a thing out of it, make a party out of it, kind of extend.
It'd be more fun.
Yeah. Extend the good times. And so, you know, not only is it, you know, incredibly difficult to physically get there, but then you've got to have everything you possibly need. Whereas with the Porcupine Freedom Festival, like we just attended this week, you can show up with, you know, a tent, a sleeping bag, and some money in your pocket, and you'll be all right. You know, you're going to have food. There's yep. people there that have food. You're just down the road from the Shaws. You can go and you can stop there and, you know, get your own food if you need to, if you don't want to pay the people to prepare it for you there on the campsite. But, you know, you're relatively fine at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. If you don't pack everything you need into Burning Man, well, then you have to depend on the charity of others. And the people that are at Burning Man are very charitable people. They understand this is like a sort of an experiment in this communal living, this giving gift economy that they have there. And you are given things. Like, there are people who bring food specifically to give it away to people.
There are probably people that go with no food specifically with the intent of getting a bunch of free food.
That know that they'll get it free.
I have probably a real problem with the idea of a gift economy.
I do too.
I think it's a fine idea to experiment or whatever. But, I mean, you know, it's just... You know, there's going to be moochers.
I'm not sure we should argue too much with what works. And Burning Man, you know, as much as I might criticize their interactions with the government, they are first rate in terms of, I mean, they're the top festival in the country, aren't they?
Yep.
It's got to be.
You know, they must be doing something right.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
So, but just, you know, just looking at what it would take to get there. If you want to rent an RV, okay, that's cool. It's costly. You know, it's not cheap to rent an RV. Yeah, you're going to be having a little more comfortable living conditions. It's not going to blow away if a dust storm comes in, which happens to people's tents. If you don't put those tents down with rebar, yep. man, your tent's going at some point during the week. And so, you know, if you got an RV, that's probably not going to blow away. But then if you're renting the RV, good luck cleaning that thing up, because all of the dust storms that come through there, let me tell you, from the people I've talked to, the RVs are coated with the dust from the desert. Mm. Like, when you drive out of there, you've got to spend serious time and money cleaning that RV up, or you're not going to get your deposit back or whatever it was that, you know, you paid down on that thing. So renting an RV is a ridiculously costly experience. And, you know, even then, if you're renting the RV, then you're driving that RV across the country. I mean, it's a lot of work.
I go
to
Burning Man
thing.
When someone pays me $25 an hour plus expenses to do it.
Yeah. It's a lot of work to do it. But if somebody were to have a really sweet VIP center to hang out in at Burning Man, you can't blame somebody.
It almost feels like they're making their own little Dien Bien Phu there. You know, like we're going to build this, you know, location right in the middle of all the natives who are angry at us, and we're just going to make an outpost and make our stand here, right? But happens if the natives actually really do get angry?
And torch the place.
No, these natives are not angry.
To burn the man.
These natives are still bowing down to the...
That's what the Burning Man symbol should look like, I guess. The Burning Man should be burned in the
bowing
position
man.
Of bowing, yeah.
So, anyway, back to the story about Greece and the bank holiday decision. They made this decision today to have tomorrow as a bank holiday, as ATMs have been running out of money and tensions are running high as Greeks stood in line for hours, this according to the Washington Post, to scrape together petty cash for basic supplies. Lines mounted at gas stations as worried residents topped off their tanks for what could be a period of time in a cashless nation. Quote, the decision is not to prolong financial aid. The decision not to prolong financial aid to Greece is offensive, and it's a disgrace for Europe in general. Says,
oh, no, it's not.
This is the Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras saying in a brief Sunday evening address broadcast across Greek television networks. He said he was seeking an extended and enlarged bailout from European lenders that would carry the country past Tuesday.
Another one.
When it will otherwise face default. That's right.
I have two phrases for the German government on this one. Well, if, assuming Germany really runs Europe, which it probably does. I say, vielen Dank, and what's the other one? Ευχαριστώ. So that's thank you in Greek and thank you in German for abandoning these Greek big spenders.
There were signs that Greece's creditors...
At some point or another, like the consequences of your actions have to come home for you to change behavior. And I get the Greek people, they're having lots of problems there, but the Greek government has not had consequences for their actions. What they're doing is they're shifting
blame.
They
want to push the ball down the road.
They're not just pushing the ball down. They're saying, "My God, he kicked the ball down the road." I mean, it's their spendthrift behavior is coming home to roost, and they don't want to admit that's the problem.
According to the story here at the Post, there were signs that their creditors, the IMF and Eurozone governments, were leaving the door open to negotiations, but it remained deeply unclear ahead of Tuesday's IMF repayment deadline how Greece would be able to satisfactorily arrange its finances. Spiros said the threat by European Union leaders to hold Greece to the deadline and not extend further assistance amounts to blackmail. Yeah, if you don't pay your debt by the deadline, you're being blackmailed, apparently, yeah, according to this guy. 855 450 free. More coming up.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet, or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio, now at your fingertips.
Have you ever wondered if you could make electric, light, or heat in your home for free? How about a motor that charges batteries at the same time? What if this also restores useless batteries and saves you lots of money? Come to our Renaissance Charge Conference Workshop on August 15th and 16th in Fort Lauderdale. Visit r-charge.com. That's r-charge.com for details. Or call 208-304-2954. 208-304-2954.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
We're back with Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition, back here in our Keene studios. By the way, I haven't been mentioning it because I'm out of the habit now. Last week at Pork Fest, where we haven't had Skype. But we've got it now since we're back in our regular studio. So if you want to call us on Skype to share your thoughts, it doesn't have to be about what we've been discussing, the Bureau of Land Management's ridiculous demands on Burning Man, the Greece situation that is looking more dire by the moment as the Greek government and the banks have declared a bank holiday for tomorrow, which means that all the people who want to get their money out of their banks aren't going to be able to. And, of course, that's not good because who knows what the next steps will be as far as the desperate measures these government guys take as they the deadline looms on the payback that they're supposed to make to their creditors.
Overlords.
The International Monetary Fund and the Eurozone governments who've loaned a billion plus dollars. I think it was $1.6 billion last numbers I looked at to them. And so, you know, comment on anything you want. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm. Just send a contact request, and then we will approve it as soon as we notice it come through. Actually, Peacekeeper 2.0, I want to tell you, they are working on it. They are doing a fundraiser. Peacekeeper 1.0 was a great idea. The idea, let's decentralize protection services. Let's make it so people who want to help others can actually do so through the app called Peacekeeper. So the idea is if there's something happening to you or your loved one, they send an alert out via Peacekeeper. Let's say it's an abduction, a fire, some sort of medical emergency. You send out the appropriate alert. Your friends, your family members, your neighbors, they get that alert. They can respond maybe faster than 911 could. That's kind of the basic concept behind Peacekeeper, and it was a great idea. But there were some bugs with the original software. There were some problems, and the designer, he's admitting to it, and he wants to find solutions. He's going to hire a new programmer to build in some awesome new features into Peacekeeper 2.0. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement, a revolutionary system designed to challenge the status quo, and it's a tool that will allow ordinary people like you to stand up and be a hero. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can help keep you safe better than dialing 911. But they need your help to get to version 2.0, and they're doing an Indiegogo fundraiser right now over at pk.freetalklive.com. That'll actually take you to their Indiegogo site, but it's easier to give you the PK link. pk.freetalklive.com will take you right to the Indiegogo page for Peacekeeper 2.0, where you can help revolutionize what protection means. Go to pk.freetalklive.com. So the current boss man over there in Greece, the Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras, I'm sure I'm pronouncing his name wrong, but anyway, that's my best shot, said the threat by the European Union leaders to hold Greece to the deadline. Now, this is an agreement, right? When you enter into an agreement with somebody, there's hopefully, if it's a good agreement, some sort of parameter on it, like, oh, Mark, I'm going to loan you this $500. You need to have it paid back by this date. And if you don't pay it back by this date, here's what happens. I mean, this is just a standard kind of contractual thing here. It's not blackmail to say, hey, Mark, you better pay me by this date. And right. If you don't pay me by this date, well, whatever we wrote in our contract will come true.
It's blackmail if you believe Marxism. right? And that's what these people are. They're not even soft Marxists. They're pretty hard Marxists.
On the other hand, you know, as hard as I'm being on Greece, there's also a dark side on Germany's side, because it's just, as Ron Paul said, Germany is getting maneuvered into the position where it's selecting the prime ministers of Greece, or are exercising veto power over who can be the prime minister of Greece.
Now, why does
Germany
have so much sway?
Well, I mean, I always tend to assume when I think the word Europe, I think Germany. I mean, Germany's the economic driver.
They are the continental
power. If it hadn't
been
for all the wars in the last century, Germany would have dominated the continent a long time ago. Hmm. It's just naturally happening now economically, since there's no wars. But yeah, I mean, that was Ron Paul's beef, was that they were gaining too much influence over Greek politics, and it was starting to get to the point where they were almost able to veto prime ministers. I think that might have kind of been thrown back in the Germans' face the last time they tried it, but
I wonder how many Bitcoin vending machines there are over there in Greece and how busy those have been recently. The decision to close the banks came after the European Central Bank announced today that it would not enlarge an emergency loan program that has been a vital lifeline in the recent weeks to Greece's overextended financial
belly.
Fearful Greeks have been pulling their money out of the banks, worried they could lose access to it altogether or that it could turn into a less valuable currency in the event that Greece is kicked out of the euro. Greek bank officials said that around $1.1 billion, hold on a sec, this is an amazing number, right? $1.1 billion was withdrawn from banks over this weekend.
That's really, really bad.
No, I think it's good. It has to happen. It just go through it. Just do it. Get it over with. I mean, this crisis has been going on in Greece too long. It should have been ended, although, you know, at least at this point, it hasn't been very violent. That's good, and that needs to not change. But they need to go through this process. It's like a cleaning.
However, the European Central Bank also decided not to eliminate the emergency assistance altogether, a step that would have caused immediate bank failures and quickly cast Greece out of the eurozone. Greek finance officials also pledged today to do all they could to keep their nation on an even keel.
Why would they want to be in the eurozone? I beg to be more regulated.
Well, I don't know that much about the eurozone. There's people that know a lot more, but aren't there tremendous advantages as far as trade goes, being in the eurozone?
Well, I mean, it's like maybe the eurozone is imposing fewer penalties on countries that are in it than they do on countries that are not in it.
Well, okay, so it's not being in the eurozone that's the problem. The problem is the government of Greece's over expenditures. They could be doing just fine, just like...
No, if I was in the eurozone, I would not feel just fine. every country that goes into that black hole is like a domino falling on the road to communism.
Well, Europe is already on the road to communism. I mean, you know, they're already pretty socialist.
But at least
states.
It was divided before. Like, you had little Finnish communism here, and you had a little Swedish communism there, and you had a little, you know, Bosnian communism there. But it was always different. You could at least get up and move, right? And you wouldn't be under the same system.
But getting up and moving is kind of the point of the eurozone. Is they're able to move. European citizens are able to move from one place to another.
They could move before that, right?
Yeah, they could immigrate, but now it's not so much immigration. They could immigrate before. Now what's going on is like same boss, you know, meet the same boss, he's everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, it's the problem we wouldn't have, you know, or it's the problem we have in the United States, where the feds are everywhere. You know, this fascist government goes everywhere in this huge landmass. It would be so much better if all we had to deal with was the New Hampshire government. Would we need to have a movement?
Rob is in Lynchburg, Virginia, listening to WLNI. Hello, Rob.
I can't believe you guys can tie the Greek situation to, like, the free state movement. That was really – that was awesome.
That's cool. What we do.
But look, you know, Margaret Thatcher said socialism works until you run out of other people's money.
Mm-hmm.
It's just they're lazy. They don't want to work, okay? They have 10 people that get a pension at age 50 because they're a hairdresser, because they say, oh, well, that's hazardous chemicals year-round. That's the same thing as being a firefighter or a policeman. The whole system is just set up to suck money from the countries that work, i.e. Germany, Sweden, France. They're just lazy. It's not a difficult thing to understand. They don't
work. I don't know if it's lazy. Isn't that sort of greedy?
Well, also, to the Greeks' credit, most of the Greeks don't. Apparently, a lot of Greeks don't pay their taxes, which is awesome.
Right. Well, I mean, but if you want benefits from the government and you refuse to pay taxes, I think that falls in the realm of greed.
Well, it falls into the realm of human.
It does, but it's unacceptable behavior.
It doesn't work if you want cradle-to-grave socialism for the government to pay everything, and you don't want to work to generate the money, and then you cheat on your taxes. And then they're angry, just like all socialists, you know, they're angry because they can't get somebody else's money because, you know, it's real nice getting someone else's money. And people get real used to someone else paying all their bills. Mm. And there will be violence in Greece. There, you know, there will be.
The taxi cab drivers are flipping cars over and setting them on fire in France over Uber. I mean,
yeah, that's crazy.
Absolutely. Wait. I mean, these people are statist.
Well, I think to their credit, there has not been a lot of violence in Greece. And hopefully that bodes well for the collapse that we'll have.
I suspect.
Well, yeah, that's a very good point. That because this is very much foreshadowing. We're no better than them. We've been following the same policies. We just have the Bretton Woods Agreement, so we get to pretend that our paper dollars are gold. And you know, people have already stopped buying. Our credit has been cut off. No one's paying the United States any money. We just have the Fed buying its own money and pretending they're just doing QE5. And, you know, the Federal Reserve is just buying the bonds because when you go to an auction on the real world and actual businesses and say, hey,
nobody
will you
them.
Loan the U.S. government money? Nobody will buy it.
Yeah, you're
we're
right
free.
About that. That's one of the Federal Reserve's primary roles is to be the lender of last resort. If nobody else wants to buy those bonds, they'll do it. And that just means they're printing more money out of thin air. Rob, I wish we had more time. Good call. Thanks for making it tonight. Now might be a good time to look at getting some Bitcoin with the situation over there in Greece. We'll keep our eyes on it, and you can join us tomorrow online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. And don't forget to join Dave Ridley at ridleyreports.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the White Mountains of New Hampshire, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, June 28, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.82 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,000.